this until I decide it's a good time to stop the stream. I'm just saying I don't want this stream to lag and then crash and then I have to start over. That would be disappointing. Alright, before we get started, I gotta do the thing. The amazingly productive thing that I always do when I start streaming, which is called plug myself in all the necessary places. This is very important. Trust me. Alright, I hope I got everything. Oh gosh, I don't know if I got everything. Because I'm gonna be honest, I just always forget the things I'm supposed to do to get ready for a stream. Let's see, I've got my water. That is the number one most important thing, so that's good. At the very least, I have my water. I'm actually playing the game. That's also good. I hope the sound is okay. According to my computer, the sound is okay, but I can't actually hear it, so maybe my computer's lying to me. That wouldn't be very nice, but I guess there's no way I can stop it. Let's see, plug myself. I think I'm good to go. If I'm not, that's unfortunate, but what am I supposed to do? We're just going to hop right back into this. I don't know if I'm going to finish the game today. Probably not, because it's late. Well, it's late-ish. It's like 6 p.m. or 6:30 where I am. So, I don't know how much is left in the game, but I don't know if I'm going to be able to finish it. Yeah, I guess whether or not I finish this game today really depends on how much is left. Although, it's going to be pretty difficult to tell until I actually finish. Yeah, let's just hop right into it. What happened last time? Kibo went rogue, right? He started bombing the school. Well, not in that way. In a good way, right? Because there's a good way to to blow stuff up. He was trying to save everyone. So that's the good way. Because sometimes you can... Well, maybe I shouldn't be condoning violence. But you get what I'm trying to say. I don't know who this is, so I don't really have a voice for them, but I do gotta get my throat ready for all these voices. Gotta remember him too. Oh yeah, Kaito's dead, which is like very sad. It was even more sad because I thought he died and then he did die, so then he was back, but then he just immediately died again. So like, sometimes life, I guess life just doesn't go the way we plan sometimes, but gotta roll with the punches because this game ain't gonna finish itself. Oh, I guess I should introduce myself. I knew it. It's my boy. Alright, let's see. What should Makoto's voice be? I was thinking something British-ish. It's not even gonna be close to his voice. My name's Makoto. I don't have any talents or anything. I'm just a regular teenager.
That doesn't look like Makoto.
Whoa, is this really the same Makoto I grew up with?
See? Even the way I look is normal.
This, okay.
Getting into an elite school like this is just the start of my bad luck. I can't keep up with my classmates' conversations or the teacher's lectures. I'm just treated like empty space in the classroom. At home, my parents are constantly on my
face. What's going on?
Honestly, I'm fed up.
This.
I want to run away from my daily life. I want to run away and just forget all this.
Is this a different Makoto? First of all, Makoto doesn't have a bull haircut.
I want to run away. And run away. And run away and run away and run away. But I'm okay. I have a reason to live. I've got something to look forward to.
Yeah, Pokemon Sword and Shield. That's what we got to look forward to. This man's gonna be there opening night, I can tell. He's gonna be camping out. He's gonna have his tent all set up. He's gonna be camping out in front of Best Buy. He's gonna have one of those portable stovetop things. He's gonna be cooking some eggs and pancakes right outside Best Buy. Sword and Shield. Opening night, yep. You can tell. He looks like that kind of kid. That guy has a
Thanks for the what? Courage.
He has a nicer phone than I do. This is crazy. How can he afford that?
Thanks for giving me something to get totally obsessed with. Thanks for the strength to keep going. I'll keep on rooting for you. So please keep trying your best.
I hope he's talking to me.
And
He watched me play Pokemon one time and he was like, oh man, I want to be just as cool as this kid one day. That's what he's watching on his phone.
One day, I'll also...
Give me some money. Hey, if you can afford a phone that nice, you can afford to, you know, give me a little bit of a loan. Ha, get it? Because I'm the loaner, too. Alright, now we actually got to start talking. Whoa, what happened?
What did you say?
The school building blew up. What happened? Over there. I turned my head to where Maki was pointing. Oh, it's CGI Kibo. He's a big boy now. Oh, just be careful not to hit us. Huh? Kibo! Kibo, what are you doing?
Dad?
You're flying. Is it magic? I don't know what he's planning, but it looks like he's attacking the school indiscriminately. We need to hurry and stop him. We'll get caught up in this mess if we don't. But how do we stop him?
All right.
We have to talk to him. We can get him to come down.
Hey.
It's dangerous, but let's go to the courtyard and try to get his attention.
Oh,
yeah, you're right. Okay. Confused by the situation unfolding in front of us, we ran to the center of the courtyard. Okay. It's gonna... I mean, I guess. It didn't let me move on my own. Eek. It's like a battlefield.
Damn it.
We need to get his attention. Get him to come down. Kibo, come here!
Hey!
Are you trying to get us killed?
Kibo.
Please, Kibo, come down and talk to us. I shouted out to Kibo, who finally came to a halt midair, and then slowly flew down to us.
Hey.
Here he comes. Yeah. Oh, are we CGI? No.
Did you call for me?
Yes.
Please keep it brief. I have other matters I must attend to.
Okay. I was going to say something witty and rhetorical,
huh?
But I couldn't think of anything in time, so... Other matters?
Yes.
I'm going... Okay, let's see if we can do this. I'm going to end the killing game. Is that his voice? I hope it is.
Huh?
End the killing game?
Indeed.
To do that, I must destroy the Ultimate Academy for Gifted Juveniles.
What did you say?
Destroy it.
That's right.
The killing game cannot go on if I destroy the school in its entirety.
Yippee.
So that's why you have that weapon.
Hey.
What's with that weapon and the jetpack?
Yeah.
I obtained this equipment from my lab.
Huh?
You had equipment like that in your lab?
Yes.
I made some modifications to drastically improve their power output and functionality.
Wait.
Since when have you been able to do that? You didn't level up or anything, right? Hey, I did. Look at my level 56. Man, that should be enough to take on the Elite Four, right? Or the Mastermind. The Mastermind is basically the Elite Four, right? Level 56, that seems like a good level to be. Did something happen? Didn't you say that you didn't want to use anything from the lab?
Right.
That's right. You don't like looking sci-fi.
That's right.
Yes, I wanted to be treated like a real human, a creature of flesh and blood like you all.
I have decided.
But I no longer have the luxury of clinging to that wish anymore. My course is clear. I must destroy the academy and end this killing game. Oops. Nope. Did I skip some dialogue? Nope, I didn't. I just thought I did.
Hold on. If you do something like that, we'll all die too, you know. There's no oxygen in the outside world. There are no living things. We're only able to survive because we're inside this spaceship, you know?
That's right. Are you trying to kill us too?
Yes.
If my actions result in your death, so be it. Huh? So be it. Monokuma has told us that despair is our only choice. That hope does not exist here.
Unfortunately. And he
is right. Whoa. Kibo, no. Oh, no. That's what happens when you knock off his magical antenna hair. As long as the killing game continues, only despair awaits us.
No.
Wait, we still have hope.
Remember.
Our hope is everyone here, our friends who are still alive.
Yeah,
if we all work together, even this killing game will...
100%.
I will not stop. It will never stop.
What should we do?
And even if we did manage to stop this killing game and escape, where would we go? Earth is destroyed, humanity is extinct, and we have no home to return to.
What?
That might be true, but...
Monokuma is right. Despair is all we have here. We simply do not have the power to change the outside world on our own.
Everyone!
All we can do now is refuse to submit to despair.
Hey.
And you would be willing to let all of us die to accomplish that?
Logical.
That is a far better alternative than allowing Monokuma to continue the killing game. Hold on. I got a notification. Okay, never mind.
What was that?
Are you serious?
Listen closely.
Kaito and Kokichi gave their lives to end this killing game. We should follow their example. We should be willing to give our lives to end this killing game.
What do you mean?
Is that what your inner voice is telling you to do?
No.
No, I can no longer hear that voice.
Huh?
You can't hear it anymore.
That's right.
For some reason, my inner voice has gone silent. This decision is my will, my choice.
I have decided.
I've chosen to modify myself and destroy this academy.
Everyone!
We can never submit to despair because we are students of Hope's Peak Academy.
No.
No, that's wrong.
Why?
Wrong? Because there might still be hope. There might still be a place to call home.
Well then.
And what are you basing that claim on?
That's wrong.
Nothing! Wahoo! Yeah, who needs proof? Just wing it. That's my motto. I have a lot of mottos, but that's my main one. Just wing it. Who needs a reason to do something? Who needs some proof that doing something is going to be worthwhile? If you just wing it every single time, you're going to be okay. That's my one too.
But
I just have a feeling.
You.
Just a feeling? You sound like that idiot right now.
Because.
Kaito said so. Aw, man. As if I can remember his voice. It's just like Kokichi said. If this game's rules matter so much, someone's watching. Aw, see, he knows.
Okay.
There can be no killing game without an audience. Hope's Peak Academy was the same way. It was a killing game made for an audience. This game must be the same way. Someone's watching this somewhere. There's someone left. There's still a possibility. True, we cannot say there is absolutely no possibility, but even a mere possibility,
no, that's wrong.
That possibility is our hope. Oh, we got the nice music. It's time, people.
Huh?
What?
Because.
We haven't investigated everything. There are still a lot of mysteries in this school. If there are still questions to answer, then we haven't found the truth. And that means we can't give up. We can't give up before we reach the truth. Spoken like a true ultimate detective.
I understand.
Very well, I shall cooperate with your attempt to stop this killing game your way.
Thank you.
Kibo. Yo, Kibo, solid A tier character. I don't care what anyone says. He gets talked too much trash for how solid of a character he is.
Listen closely.
But you have until dawn. I will not wait any longer than that. Until dawn?
Yeah.
The dawn here is simply an illusion projected onto the dome. If you cannot stop the killing game by dawn,
100%.
I will destroy the Ultimate Academy and end the killing game myself. What's going on? You're gonna end what now? Oh, here he is. It's your boy. He's gonna talk for himself. Brings in the goons.
Killing game.
game is forever eternal.
Look, all I'm saying is, it's five. Well, actually, no, it's five versus six. I guess if you count Monokuma, I don't know how powerful Monokuma is on his own. I've never seen him fight. But I think if you take the five Exosouls and then the five of us, it's a pretty even matchup. I mean, Himiko might not be the best character in the world, but at least Maki is an S-tier character. So, if as long as Himiko can pull like a finish off half an Exosoul, and Maki can finish off one and a half Exosouls, we should be okay.
He's back.
Attempting to destroy this precious academy is more than a violation of school regulations. It's an act of mutiny.
That's enough.
So what? You are solely mistaken if you think I will allow this to continue.
Huh? Is the robot malfunctioning? He must be. Why else would he try to defy me?
Oh, now I gotta remember these guys' voices too.
Let's kill him until he dies from it. Heck yeah!
Ripping a robot apart isn't gory at all, so I can go all out this time.
And that's that.
Pops, can we kill him, please?
They're so brazen because they don't have any hair downstairs.
Oh, well, that's... No.
That's not very nice, Monokuma.
Well, any last words?
Alright, don't worry. We got your back, Kibo.
They're all in battle mode.
Everyone!
This place is dangerous. You all need to get out of here.
Kibo,
are you okay?
Yeah.
Shuichi, please find this truth that you mentioned earlier while I stall them.
Well,
it's all in your hands now. Now go!
Okay.
Alright. Okay, I guess we're just gonna leave.
Never forgive rule breakers. Anyone who messes with the killing game must die!
Hey, please don't kill Kibo. We've lost too many people.
Exosouls,
yeah, but you know what? Kibo got this.
Let you run amok anymore. This killing game is over. In the name of Hope's Peak Academy, the symbol of hope is.
Keyboard, just promise me you're gonna come back to us.
I will destroy the Ultimate Academy and bring down this monument to despair.
That's how it began, in the war between Kibo and the Exosouls. The Ultimate Academy became a battlefield. Alright, so now we gotta go do something. Kibo's doing Ultimate Robot stuff. We gotta go do Ultimate Detective stuff. Chapter 6. Goodbye, Danganronpa. Whoa, don't say goodbye, Danganronpa. What about number 4? We gotta have a number 4, right? I mean, I guess we don't have to. I'm just saying, if number 4 came out, I might spend $60 on it. And I mean, if you're working at Spike Chunsoft, $60, that'll pay for... That should pay for at least a nice trip out to dinner. I don't know. Sounds like it's worth it. We ran to the entrance hall trying to escape the battle that was unfolding. Okay, but now what? I mean, I know there's still the door behind the bookcase in the library, but I don't know where it leads. I don't know if there's anything worthwhile finding beneath. I guess that's the only place to go, though, right? Like, where else would I go besides that bookcase?
Things have suddenly become really bad.
So the robot uprising finally happened. It's what I always feared, but
why
I never expected it'd be like this.
Why?
But why did Monokuma leave a weapon like that in the research lab? He's pretty careless, isn't he?
I'm not scared. I'm not scared.
Right?
Hey, what should we do?
Remember.
Just as I said before, we need to find the truth in order to end this killing game.
What's that mean?
But what do we need to look for?
Obviously, we need to find the real identity of the mastermind behind the killing game.
What?
The mastermind? Is there really a mastermind in this academy?
Because.
If the outside world is destroyed, then the mastermind must be in this school, right? Kokichi wasn't the mastermind. Then in that case...
I don't know.
But I thought the only ones who saved by the Gopher Project were us 16 students.
Nope.
Don't you think it's possible someone may have infiltrated the Gopher Project?
That's right.
That someone could be the mastermind hiding somewhere in this school.
Someone? You mean a remnant of despair, right? Then someone else inside this academy besides Kokichi is a remnant of despair?
That's true.
If we can find them and kill them, then this killing game should end. I don't know about killing them, but there is the possibility that the mastermind is hiding somewhere in this academy. This complex is huge. There must be places we haven't explored yet.
Right.
It seems like it's worth a shot.
But
and that's not the only thing we have to find. To truly end this killing game, we must find the mastermind of despair. And also find hope.
Huh?
Hope?
Remember.
Our home, where we're going to live after this killing game ends. I know there's hope out there. We have to find it before we leave. This isn't some fictional story, so I don't think things will work out that well. But if we look for it, we might just find it. If we don't try, we'll never find anything.
Okay.
So we have to try.
That's true.
Since Kibo is distracting the Exosols, we won't have to worry about violating school rules.
Okay.
There must be other rooms that we haven't investigated yet.
Right.
You're right, there's no point complaining. Let's all just do what we can.
Mm. Well, if we all work together, everything will be alright, right?
Okay.
Yeah, it shouldn't be difficult. No matter how impossible it seems, we'll accomplish it. Maki.
Okay.
Yeah, that's right. Let's do this thing. Look, I know where we're supposed to go. We need to find the hope and despair hidden in this academy. When all is revealed, this killing game will end. Investigate.
Mm-hmm.
Then let's split up and start searching. Mm-hmm. We're gonna split up, but we were just in such a united mood.
Well, we don't have enough time left to all go together, unfortunately.
You're right.
Right, we'll see each other soon. Okay, alright, I should go too. We need to end this killing game before dawn. Well, don't break anything that we need to find. What's going on? What just happened? What did you do? I said don't break anything. What a hole. Now it is time to test your bonds with your friends. The time to dawn and your bond with your friends will be displayed. If your bond increases, you can move large debris. What? So work hard to end this killing game before dawn breaks. What? There's a staircase. Why is there a staircase here? Was this staircase supposed to be unlocked by a mysterious item? There must be clues here. I have to investigate. All right, we're going downstairs. Seriously, why is there a staircase here? What is this? How do I... Okay, there we go. We have a time limit. I guess we should run then. This feels too easy. I can't. Oh, I guess we have to shoot them in an order, right? No. Wait. Oh, am I not close enough? Oh, come on. Really gonna be like that? Yo, we got a time limit. Don't be like that. What is this? It's broken. But from this door. This must be an ultimate lab. So this must be the ultimate supreme leader's lab. It isn't open, but there's only one ultimate lab left. It's Kokichi's, the ultimate supreme leader's lab. This door isn't supposed to open. Per the rules, if a student dies before their ultimate research lab is opened, then that lab will remain closed. Hey, it's broken. But Kibo's explosive broke the door. I should be able to get inside. I have to go inside. Yeah, we're just gonna crawl through there, because we're really about it. I mean, this does look like a Kokichi-type lab. So this is Kokichi's lab. It certainly does have that evil organization feel. But there's nothing that would identify the remnants of despair. Let's show him that that the students of Hope's Peak Academy will never submit to despair. Hope? Despair? I don't remember Kokichi's voice. Maybe I just... At that time, Kaito was in the Exosol, but it didn't seem like he knew anything about the remnants of despair. Kokichi and Kaito weren't there when we used the flashback light. But even without that memory, the truth is the same. If this lab was made for Kokichi, there should be some link to the remnants. Perhaps it's hidden somewhere? I should investigate thoroughly. Alright, let's see. Look at the central chair. Look at this. This is Kokichi's chair, definitely something a supreme leader would sit in. But something feels off. It's all too cliche. It feels as if this entire room is just an elaborate prank. Okay, that doesn't help. Okay, let's look at this shelf. A large table, one I imagine is used for strategy meetings. There's nothing of any particular interest on top of the table. Helicopter. A toy helicopter? Is this Kokichi's? What is this? What is this? Helicopter control. That... Are you kidding me? That was not very useful, but it looks like the control is over there. Alright, what about the supercar? A supercar? Is this the kind of thing that members of this evil organization drive around? But would an evil organization really want to drive around in such a flashy cars? This is more like a child's idea of what an evil organization would have. The showcase. Boom. Look at this. Look at all this cool stuff. He has afros. He could. Hey, this is some pretty cool stuff, not gonna lie. He had a collection. There are matching shoes and suits of many colors here. If this is the Ultimate Supreme Leader's lab, are these uniforms for the other members of the organization? There are some unsettling objects here. Gas masks, handcuffs. There are also wigs and glasses for disguises, I imagine. But they seem comical. This doesn't seem like something the Remnants of Despair would use. Yeah, it looks like that's everything except for this. The emblem. Alright, show me what I want to see. This must be the emblem of the organization that Kokichi leads. But do the Remnants of Despair put up emblems? Isn't that everything? I mean, there's obviously the monitor, but... Oh, wait, there's this thing on the ground. The book. I didn't see it. There's a collection of files here, bound like a book. The Complete History of Hope's Peak Academy. I picked up the book and began rapidly flipping through the pages. And inside... Dun, dun, dun. Ooh, spoiler alert. Information on Hope's Peak Academy, Future Foundation, and the Remnants of Despair. This is a history of the battle between hope and despair. But we've already remembered all this. We know this information. I don't suppose it'd make for a particularly useful clue. I don't suppose. No, something's not right. Yeah. Something's not right. I have no idea what's not right, but something is off. Because the things written in this book... What's going on? Do you really have time to read a book? Look, this is important. I'm using my big brain to solve this mystery. You wouldn't understand. I'm kidding. I'm kidding. Maki is the second biggest brain in this game, right behind yours truly. Ah, Maki. I flinched in surprise as Maki peeked at the thick book in my hands. The Complete History of Hope's Peak Academy. What's the point of reading this now? You already remembered Hope's Peak Academy with the flashback light, didn't you?
No.
Yeah, I thought as well.
Hey.
Ah, Maki, this is perfect timing. Will you come with me? For what?
Is that all right?
I need you to tell me everything you remember about the history of Hope's Peak Academy.
Why?
But why?
That's...
I need to check something important. I don't really understand, but I just need to talk about it, right? She gave me a big, almost theatrical sigh, then started speaking in bored narration. Ah, I found the... No, I'm just kidding. I don't know.
Ultimate despair.
Alright.
In order
and the world into utter despair. She organized the Killing Game at Hope's Peak Academy 78th class. Trapped by the ultimate despair, the 78th class was forced to participate in the Killing Game.
Right. Okay. I don't see the...
Junko and Oshima died at the hands of the very Killing Game she masterminded. With her death, the despair outbreaks ended, and the world slowly began to recover. But the remnants of despair continued to carry out Junko's legacy of despair. The Future Foundation was established to fight against them, and their war raged until one day, when the war suddenly ended.
The meteorites, right? We can skip that part. Is that all right?
Do you remember anything about the new Hope's Peak Academy? As for Hope's Peak Academy...
It was later rebuilt by former members of the Future Foundation and resumed operations. They continued to scout students who possessed ultimate level talent. And that's all we know.
I don't know what is suspicious. This doesn't make sense. No, that doesn't make sense, because what Maki just told me is exactly what I remember. Then what is written in this book? Are these just lies? Or are they... I turned to one of the pages almost without thinking.
What's wrong?
No.
Ah, it's just the afterword written on the last page. It says that these documents were collected by several esteemed researchers. This is the most thorough, accurate book written on the subject. Well, it says it's the complete history, so what's the problem? The problem is, if this is true... History of Hope's Peak has been added to the truth bullet section of your monopad. I don't get it! Where's the clue? Where's the hint? We can't ignore these inconsistencies. I should investigate more. In order to investigate this, I need to know more about Kokichi. I found this in his lab, after all. Hey. I investigated his lab, though. Oh, we gotta go to Kokichi's room now? Okay. Maki, I think I'm going to go to Kokichi's room now. Why Kokichi's room? I have to verify something. I have to determine which things he said were the truth and which were lies.
Okay.
Including if he really was a remnant of despair. There's no doubt that he was a remnant of despair, because in that memory...
Okay.
Well, whatever. If that's what you want to do, then I won't stop you.
Thank you.
I never would have imagined this. That Kokichi's lie might be the breakthrough we need to find the truth. What happened? What's going on? What is this? What's happening? Yo, let's not do this. What's going on? We're just evolving. We hit level 57, and that's the level that Shuichi evolves into Mega Shuichi. Oh, it's the bull haircut kid. Wait, what?
Hey, what's going on?
Hello. Are you one of the chosen for the Gopher Project?
Is bull haircut kid the remnant of despair?
Gopher Project?
I saw you on a flyer on the ground.
Oh.
That's the remnants of despair is doing. Gopher Project participants are classified.
Are you one of them? I'm really good at remembering faces.
Wait. I was gonna look at the, cause I was like, what if that kid is? Oh, we got. What did we get? Oh yeah, we got his jacket. Oh, dang it. Rest in peace, Kaito. I was gonna look at this and see if he resembled anybody. He always wore a beanie. I would have no idea. I guess if he grew his hair out, he could be Kokichi, right? Maybe. I don't know. That's actually it. I don't think that kid was the bad guy. Unless he's in this school and he's just not one of the students.
Yeah, get that a lot. Just a case of mistaken identity, I'm afraid. They're all students from Hope's Peak Academy, aren't they? I'm just a normal high school student. I don't have any special talent.
Wait.
I see. But You look just like him.
Don't worry about that. Hey, listen, should you really be outside right now? The meteor...
I'm not scared of them. Because my dad told me the Future Foundation will take care of those meteorites. If the Gopher Project succeeds, then the meteorites won't fall down.
Oh, sorry, my bad. I forgot to mute my phone, so you probably heard that. That was actually an alarm, not a notification, but my bad.
Have you heard the rumor? All the participants died in an accident.
You're wrong! They didn't die!
I don't get it.
How would you know that?
Because those people are the heroes that will save the world, right?
The Gopher Project wasn't created to save us. Never mind.
Heroes don't die! Heroes don't give up!
This is supposed to be our hope, right? We're supposed to be getting hope from the bull haircut kid?
That's why they're still alive! Because they're heroes!
We're heroes. He's telling us that we're heroes, and that means we can't heroes? Die. And that's what we needed to remember. That was a memory, right?
No.
It's from that flashback light. Oh, right, I forgot about that. This flashback light has a special effect.
Is this...
Shuichi, just now.
Okay.
That must have been the flashback light, the one that Monokuma used after Kaito's trial. After Kaito's trial?
Hey.
What did you remember? That memory was from when I tried to get away from the Gopher Project and threw away my talent.
Oh, yeah.
I remembered the same thing. But why? Why did Monokuma give us that memory? And will we experience another flashback like the one we just saw? I don't know, but I can't hesitate now.
Hey!
Maki, let's focus on the investigation. There are a lot of things we need to check.
Well...
You're heading to Kokichi's room, right? Then I'll go with you. You will?
Because...
Something about him concerns me. That's why I want to check. She looks worried. That flashback... Okay. No. The answer to that question is no, so yeah, that's the answer. No, nothing, let's go. Even so, a hero, huh? Friendship power up, 1. Yo, we're gonna become super powerful. You have increased your bond, you can move more debris than before. Can we warp? Will they actually let us warp during a time challenge? Of course they won't. Nope, you gotta run. Gotta use them legs, them thighs. And calves. Oh, I get it. Now that we have the friendship power of 1. Nice, we're now level 57. Now we're gonna Mega Evolve. Mega Evolve into Mega Medicham. Mega Medicham has the biggest calves in the world, dude. Oh my god. I'm trying to look like Mega Medicham. Just all thighs, all calves. Just huge, gigantic legs. And nothing else. Oh, we gotta knock these out of the way. I'm going to be high jump kicking. I'm going to be smashing entire giant things. I don't know. I was going to say buildings, but probably not buildings. Probably just regular rocks. I'm going to be... That's how powerful my legs are going to be. That's what I'm trying to do. Kokichi Oma's room. What in the world is this? Why does he have Rentara? Yeah, he has Rantaro's effigy, and it's just hanging there. Yo, he was a nut. He was a nutcase, wasn't he? I don't know where he got all this stuff, but he hoarded a lot of things. It's unsettling, but we should investigate it right. By investigating this room, we might learn more about Kokichi. Kokichi said that he was... the leader of an organization opposed to the Gopher Project. In that effort, he tried to take the position of the mastermind. The flashback light helped us remember that the organization was the Remnants of Despair. Kokichi was the leader of the Remnants of Despair. But is that the real truth? I feel as though there may be a lie in there. Oh, we can't investigate the Ifigi or that. Is this all the collected evidence? No, okay, so there's box. Yes, there's a box of documents. These, yeah, boxes of documents. There are several cardboard boxes filled with documents.
These look like blueprints.
Yo, he was trying to build a lightsaber.
And a rainbow gun?
Huh? Blueprints?
They're mostly jarrings of childish fantasy weapons like ray guns and beam swords.
Well,
I wonder if the Electrohammer and Electrobomb blueprints are here. Maybe he drew whatever came to mind and then selected a few from you to create.
I don't understand.
Looking at everything, a lot of these childish designs seem impossible to create.
That might have been Kokichi's intention.
His intention?
Remember.
He could have prepared a few fake blueprints to mask the real ones. It's nearly impossible to check all of them, lowering the chance someone would find it.
You mean there might be something important hidden among this stuff?
Right.
I believe that is a possibility, but we don't have time to look.
Then I'll do it.
Maki took a seat in front of one of the boxes and began searching the blueprints. Maki!
Thank you.
Thank you. Well, I guess no problem. Yeah, you do that. That sounds really actually boring. If I'm going to be completely blunt with you, that sounds like super boring, and that's definitely not something I would do. So I'm glad you're doing it instead. Alright, what is this? Ah, this is the hidden camera I set up in the library. And this is the inner tube that was floating in the pool. And this is the book from the caged child seance.
He was gathering all the evidence from the past incidents. The murder weapons aren't here, but why on earth was he gathering all this? No, it's pointless to try and understand what he was thinking.
Perhaps you're right. Okay. What about this? This is the last thing to look at, the Cubs pad. It's a Mono Cubs pad. They were given to all of us as motives during Kirumi's case, but the motive videos were switched up and we each got someone else's video.
That's true.
I don't believe this motive video is Kokichi's.
But there's no point in looking, is there?
No.
No, we should check. I want to know what he knew. It would explain his actions. When I touched the finger to the pad, the video started playing. Alright, let's look at this. Kokichi Oma's motive video.
By popular demand! It's time for the motive video!
Dun dun dun!
Who's the most important person in your life? And now, without further ado...
Better be me. What if they just turned on my face cam and showed a picture of me on stream? I would be totally embarrassed, because I'm kinda ugly. I'm kidding! I'm actually super handsome.
Kokichi's...
Kokichi Oma, the ultimate supreme leader.
Yo, look at this! Wearing clown masks, he really was the Joker. This is insane.
He caused mayhem the world over as the leader of the secret organization, DICE. And by mayhem, I mean petty nonviolent crimes and harmless pranks.
Well, that sounds... That's not very Joker-esque, but other than that...
Anyway, Kokichi had 10 loyal goons working for him.
Hey, that's more than I have.
These goons were like friends and family. Most important people in his life. But then, a terrible event befell those precious people.
They look like they're sick.
What kind of event? It's a secret. Find out for yourself.
So he wasn't a remnant of despair? Is that what we're trying to learn? So this was Kokichi's motive video.
Why did he have his own motive video? Did he exchange it with someone else?
No.
Or maybe he was given his own motive video from the start, like Kirumi.
Oh, so Kirumi wasn't the only one who got their own motive video. Well, either way, it doesn't matter anymore.
That is true, but the content of that motive video is disconcerting. It's inconsistent with the information we already know about Kokichi. But what can I deduce from that? Kokichi's motive video has been added to the Truthbullet section of your monopad. I never thought that a motive video would be a concern now. Kokichi gathering all those pieces of evidence was coincidence, right? Wait, was he trying to gather evidence because he was trying to figure out if what everything that Monokuma said was going down was actually going down? But do I need to talk to you now? We don't have infinite time. We gotta hurry this up.
Hey, I wanted to ask you something.
What is it?
Kaito believed Kokichi. He believed that someone's watching this killing game.
What do you mean?
What do you think?
Kokichi does have a compelling point. This killing game only makes sense if there's an audience. Why else would there be all these rules designed to make it more interesting? It's like Junko Enoshima's killing game from the past. Monokuma is particularly strict about upholding the rules and livening up the killing game. Is it because someone's watching? But we're all that's left of humanity, aren't we?
I don't understand.
Even if he did say it was to show someone, no one else is alive anywhere else, right? I wonder if someone really did infiltrate this place. Okay. That is a mystery. But all mysteries conceal some truth. There is still a truth to find in this killing game. Whether that truth is hope or despair is another matter entirely. Without a truth bullet? Yeah, the killing game has been added to the truth bullet section. That covers just about everything in Kokichi's room.
Hey.
If you're done, we can leave. I'm going to check the blueprint. Oh, you can leave. I'm going to check the blueprint. But
because
we rely on you the most, especially in this situation. After all, you're Kaito's sidekick, Maki.
No.
But before you go, I found something strange that I want you to look at.
Huh?
Something strange? What is this? Is this a real will? I mean, it says this isn't a will, so I think it is a real will, but I wouldn't be surprised if it's fake. He was a liar, after all. But if it is real, why did he leave it? He left us this information in case his plan failed.
Huh?
He did? I didn't think he would do something like that.
Well,
we should look inside, then we'll know more. When I opened the envelope, small pieces of paper fell out.
Huh?
Wait, what? A second message, the wall next to the boiler. That's all. It's probably another one of his horrible pranks. I'm not sure about that. I should investigate just in case. It might be another important clue. Wait, what did it say? Do you want... Do what you want. I don't want to waste any time. It'll be dawn before you know it.
Okay.
Yeah. Alright, I should head to the boiler in the garden. Oh, I gotta run there too. Alright, let's go. Gotta hurry up. We don't got time to be lollygagging. Look at this. I'm gonna fight you. Hey, square up. Hey, where do you think you're going? Square up right now. Bow, bow, bow. Okay. I beat him. I just wanted to say I beat him. It just couldn't show it on stream because it was too violent. I really just shredded that robot in a way that was so violent that it wasn't even PG-13. Wait. Where does this lead? What the heck is this? Why can't I go here? What? Unfair! Obviously... Okay. You know what? Fine. That's obviously not where I'm supposed to go yet, but that's clearly important. For something. You're not just gonna put a path there that leads to nothing. Alright, where's this message? This is the boiler room, right? The wall next to the boiler. What could it be? Perhaps it's just a prank. Oh, that's what... I don't see anything. Here we go. What did this say? Around here? This area used to be covered in grass, but it's been completely removed. It shouldn't be hard to find it now. I let out a gasp when I saw it. Twins B. I don't know what that means, but okay. Is this the second message? What could this possibly mean? If it was written by Kokichi, like the other message, aren't they meant to be read together? In that case, it seems as though the message is incomplete. Two This World is Mine by Kokichi Oma and Twins B. Two mysterious messages has been added to your truth bullet section of your monopad. But if this is incomplete, what was Kokichi trying to do by telling us? Oh, more memories. We're evolving again into Ultra Shuichi. That's right, now he can use Z-moves too. Super broken. Imagine Mega Shuichi that can use a Z-move. That sounds super broken, if I have to say so myself. I mean, Shuichi is already a broken character. He carries every single trial. Oh, who's that? Oh, that's Makoto, isn't it? That's definitely Makoto. All right, let's do this British voice. Shuichi Saihara. No, that's not British. Shuichi Saihara, do you have your ultimate memory back?
Yes.
As the headmaster of Hope's Peak Academy, I want to ask you to please cooperate with the Gopher Project. I do feel bad about this. I know how much you all wanted to run, even if it meant no longer being Ultimates. Those of you who have to live on like this might be the real victims here. But the only people who can go through with this project are you 16 who haven't been infected. The fate of humanity rests on your shoulders.
Huh? Even if this ridiculous mission is a success and we all survive, what's the point? Why try so hard to save the seeds of humanity? I don't understand.
Perhaps you'll be the ones who will create that point. Huh? It's true that the situation you're all being forced into is harsh. So harsh that you think it'd be better to just die. But I still want you all to live. For those of us who want to live but can't, you 16 who can live are...
Hey, Codename Hawkhead. I'm at that part? I don't know. Am I at that part? I'm on chapter 6. If that's that part, then yeah, I'm at that part.
Hope itself. So please, I don't want to see you give up on hope. I want you to keep hope alive.
Okay. I don't know what I was supposed to get from that memory, but okay. We got it. That was clearly something. My head. I remembered something again. We were at Hope's Peak, and we gathered in the Gopher Project. At that moment, I heard something crumbling above me. Oh, no. Hey, be careful. Be careful. I'm in here. Don't squash me. Okay, I'm alive. That's all that matters. I didn't die. Whew, that was a close one. Not quite, but still juicy info. Kibo! Alright, Kibo, I need your friendship power to move bigger rocks. I'm going to absorb your strength. We're gonna do one of those Dragon Ball Z fusion type things, and we're gonna become really powerful. Honestly, if Kibo and Shuichi combined in a fusion, like a Dragon Ball fusion, that would be the most powerful character in all of Danganronpa. Like, Shuichi carried every single trial, right? And Kibo, while he didn't carry every single trial, he was useful in every single trial. Also, he's a robot. So you combine the most big brain character in the Danganronpa universe with the most powerful character in the Danganronpa universe, you just get an unstoppable character. It would truly be...
Right?
Shuichi, what's wrong? Are you alright? Kibo. Okay. Yeah, I'm okay. I'm sorry, I experienced a sudden flashback and my hand slipped.
Then...
Did you remember too, Kibo?
Yeah.
Yes, we were at Hope's Peak Academy, about to sign on for the Gopher Project.
But...
What is Monokuma thinking, having us remember that now? He's probably trying to make us feel despair again.
Despair?
No, but these memories... Kibo, talk to me. How is your investigation going? Will you be able to end the killing game your way? It's going fine. I really just started. There are a lot of areas in this academy we haven't investigated. Areas that you can't investigate. Rantaro's lab is also inaccessible thanks to Monokuma's ridiculous rule. That's right, I'm concerned about that too. If only there was some way to get in. I will help you.
Help me?
By destroying the door to his research lab so you can enter it. If you could, that would really help. Then please head to his lab and I will meet you there. But be careful. Monokuma will be after you for conducting an investigation without his permission. The exosomes may not kill you outright, but they will definitely try to stop you.
Okay,
right.
Listen closely.
If things get dangerous, call me and I will deal with the exosomes. You're going to help me, Kibo?
Yeah.
I am not your enemy. That is why I am helping you with your investigation. But only until the time limit expires at dawn. Alright, we got the Kibo friendship power. He should count for at least 2 friendship powers. Only until the time limit, huh? I suppose he's still bent on destroying this academy. Still, you've changed, Kibo. Is it because of the situation or because he can't hear his inner voice? Right now, I should focus on Rantaro. He died before revealing his ultimate talent, but he seemed to know more than we did. Yeah, it seemed like... Right, because our first memory that we got... Probably my favorite chapter, he says, but it's all downhill from here. Oh, downhill, don't say that. It's gotta turn out better than
this, right? We can't just die here. We gotta live. We gotta fight for hope. Hey, I have a question. This might sound a little weird, but does the term Ultimate Hunt ring a bell for anyone? Yeah, I still remember his voice. He had a nice voice. Oh, rip. No, not the internet. I hope it's not my stream crashing. I mean, it says my stream's being fine. Yeah. What was I gonna say? Oh, yeah. It seemed like Rentaro got his memories mixed up, because everyone else got their ultimate talent first, and Rentaro got the memory of the ultimate hunt first. So what's up with that? Before we even remembered that event, he knew about the ultimate hunt. Ultimate hunt. But why? There might be a clue somewhere that will lead us to the mastermind. I'm going to do everything I can. No giving up. I won't give up on hope. I need to keep hope alive. And to do that, I need to get inside Rentaro's lab. Congratulations. You've unlocked the Kibo gun. Hold A or RB or near an exosol to fill up with energy. When the energy is filled to the max, Kibo will come to save you. Use it as you need it. Okay. Look, I'm really good at this game. There's no way I'm getting taken down by an exosol. RB. Can I get in here? No. Looks like we gotta go the long way. Alright, we gotta get upstairs. Where's the stairs? Oh, where's the exosol? Sorry for interrupting. But there's info you gotta know. Oops, what's the info we gotta know? Hold on! Hold A or RB when near an exosol to ask people for help. That's it. There's no check to it or anything. I'm holding A.
Leave it to me, everyone.
Intercept.
He got goaded. Oh, we don't have the power to break through that. We only have one friendship power. Alright, now where do we go?
Here. Four friendship power. Dang. Yo, we gotta hurry up. Alright, up the stairs we go. Man, why is this lab on the top floor, man? Kibo, go! Haha, got him! Man, I'm so good. I'm so good at this game. Those statues continue to creep me out. I don't like them. I see a hidden Monokuma. I want it. Now, may not be the time to be getting hidden Monokumas, but hey, who cares? Someone up here? No. Alright, bust me in, Kibo. Rantaro's lab. If Kibo breaks down this door. Alright, CGI Kibo time. Look how powerful he is.
Shuichi.
Thank you for waiting. That was one heck of an entrance. I would destroy this door at once. Please stand back, Shuichi. Okay. Bow. Cough, cough.
Please.
Well then, I leave the rest to you. If there is anywhere else you would like me to access but can't, please call me. I will blast open an entrance just like I did for you now. Does that mean we get his friendship power? And just as soon as you came, Kibo left.
Anywhere I'd like to access. If I can go anywhere with Kibo's help, does that mean I could get in there too? No, Rintaro's case. First, I need to investigate his lab. I know where he wants to go. Okay, let's go in. What is Rintaro's ultimate talent? What the heck? This doesn't help. He looks... What? I don't get it. I'm in. Finally. So this is Rentaro's lab, but what kind of a room is this? It's almost frightening. What was his talent? I thought I'd understand once I came here. Himiko!
I don't know.
I don't get it at all. Himiko!
Hey,
with that explosion, the sound of you breaking down this lab's door, that's pretty drastic.
No.
That wasn't me. It was Kibo. But what even is this place? It's got an awful atmosphere.
Okay.
It looks like it's some kind of puzzle room. So maybe he was the ultimate quiz king? And he got that title by winning game shows? I'm not sure. We should investigate first. Then I shall help you. Be happy. The legendary mage is your sidekick. Yeah, that makes me feel better. Yeah, it definitely sounds like it feels better. Alright, what is this? A laptop. There's the giant vault. There's literally not that much to investigate. It's a very weird looking room, but there's not that much to investigate. I don't get this at all. Is this a vault? But it doesn't look like a normal vault. This vault's door is like a puzzle. Look at the two dials. Yeah, they're... The dial on the right is labeled A, and it has a bunch of Chinese zodiac animals on it. Wait, doesn't the left one have them too? I guess not. The left one is something else. There's the Chinese zodiac symbols, and then there's astrological signs. Okay, I don't know anything about those, unfortunately. And the one on the left is labeled B, and it has a bunch of different astrological signs on it. So it looks like if we move both the dials to the right things, the vault will open. It says something about a hint somewhere in this academy. Was there really a hint? Am I supposed to remember? I don't remember. Maybe it's on his laptop.
Okay.
Well, we don't need to think so hard. We just gotta try every combination. I don't think we got time for that. So if there's 12 Chinese zodiac symbols and 12 astrological signs, then it's just 12 times 12. That's 144. Too many to try all the combinations at random. Then do you know the answer? Because I don't get it at all.
Hey.
Wait a minute, let me think. There's an A and B dial, one with the Chinese zodiac and the other with astrological symbols. And a hint somewhere in this academy. I'm sure I can solve this.
Hey,
I know I yelled at you just now, but talk to me when you're stuck.
That
should help you have an epiphany. I am the legendary mage after all. Yeah, thank you. You've got to be kidding me. There's no time. I have to try. I should inspect these dials. If I can't figure it out, I can ask Himiko. Okay, you know what? We're looking at the laptop first. A laptop? This looks promising. My magic's telling me this is important. There might be a clue in here. I should check. Looks like it still works. I should see what's on here.
What's the matter?
It's empty. What do you mean?
No.
There's no data in it at all.
Why
put a laptop here if it doesn't even have anything interesting on it?
You're right.
It seems like that's the case.
But...
No, but my magic reacted to something. There's gotta be something. Check it better. Check it better. Anyway, what was that about magic? Don't tell me to check it better. How am I supposed to check it better? Fine, I guess we're going into the giant vault. Actually, I have no idea what the company... There's a clue somewhere in this academy. Yup, nope, talking to Himiko. Just tell me the answer. Or at least a hint. Like, I have no idea. A hint somewhere in this academy. I wonder if it's like a diagram or some letters. It'd be a problem if it was some big object. I've almost got it figured out. Do I just not have enough mana? I feel as though I'm on the right cusp of discovering Something. Perhaps if I keep talking to Himiko, something will come up. Yeah. Give me more hints. Dude, we're almost halfway through the time limit. You gotta give me some. Dial labeled A with 12 Chinese zodiac symbols. A dial labeled B with 12 astrological symbols. So we need to think about A, B, the Chinese zodiac, and astrological signs. Those are the clues to opening this vault. I feel there was something, but... I got nothing. Let's see. There was the dragon that we put the ball into the mouth for the first unlocky thing. Is that something? Maybe? I don't know. Astrological signs? I don't know. Come on, give me something. Dude, we don't have enough time. Clue somewhere in this academy, but I just can't think of any. Maybe it was hidden really well? No, it must be a hint of some kind. There would be no point if no one saw it.
Could it be?
Some psychological blind spot.
A psychological blind spot, huh? That's a magical concept.
A magical concept.
There's a technique mages use when casting spells. For example, when we cast big spells, we add a bunch of flashy over-the-top stuff. We have the audience focus on all the stuff to hide the source of our magic.
A source of magic, like the method behind it?
Of course, my magic is very advanced, you know? Even if the source of magic for my spells was leaked, not just anyone could copy them. I usually don't need to hide it, but it's better safe than sorry.
Okay. Right.
Okay.
Maybe the clue was hidden from us like that?
Nope, I have no idea. What is it? I don't know.
We probably already saw it, but we don't know it's a clue yet.
Something we already saw. Ah! That's it, Himiko's right. Kokichi's message. This world is mine, Kokichi Oma. Horse A, twins B. Oh my goodness. But maybe Kokichi adding to that message was just a diversion? Thinking about it that way, the other message. Twins B. Those two messages are clues. Yo, that was a close one, dude. If they hadn't just actually just shown me that, I'd have never known. Twins. Where's the twins? There they are. No. Why isn't it going up? No, go up! Okay, fine. I don't get this at all. Oh, you gotta spin it. Okay, and horse. Always horse. This is a pro horse channel. Open this bad boy. What is this? Yes, it opened.
I don't know how, but it opened. But what did all this mean?
Is that all right?
The hint of the academy is the message that Kokichi wrote. It was a clue for these dials. The original message was written over.
Remember.
When Gonta first saw it, it just said horse A. Kokichi added more to it. But that was just a diversion.
Okay.
Horse A was actually the complete clue.
Oh, I see. So the A dial should be on the horse.
So the Chinese zodiac on dial A was horse. The other hint was hidden in the rear garden.
Remember.
It said twins B.
I see.
Got it. So the B dial should be on Gemini.
That's it.
Yes, the actual astrological zodiac on dial B was Gemini.
So that's what it meant. Thanks to your deductions, everything's all cleared up. But why did Kokichi add all that stuff to it?
It's true.
He was trying to make himself seem like he was the mastermind.
He needed us to believe it. He was trying to be the mastermind, causing us problems even after he's dead. He's such a pain.
Let's see what's in the vault. If it was this difficult to get in here, there must be something important inside.
I'm getting nervous. If it's okay if I barf first.
Do you feel nauseous when you're nervous? No, we gotta see what's inside. Come on. Come on, we don't got time. We don't got time for this. I peeked into the open vault and found a USB stick.
That Monokuma pattern must mean there's something here, but how do we check inside?
I could use that thing in this lab. Oh, the laptop? The only other thing inside this lab to use? I wonder.
Okay.
It looks like it still works. If I put the USB stick in here, I should be able to check the data. I grabbed the USB from the safe and plugged it into the laptop. I found a single file.
Could it be?
A video. I opened the video file and... what is it?
Hey there. Oh. I guess I don't have to introduce myself.
This was... we saw this video after trial one or... no, not trial one. Trial two, I think. In between chapters two and three. But a bunch of it was cut out. Are we getting the whole thing now? Taken by surprise, I gasped and stopped the video without thinking.
Hey! What is this?
Sorry.
That was Rantaro, right?
He probably recorded it before he died.
No, that couldn't be the case. The video was clearly recorded in Rantaro's lab. But we were only able to get inside this room just now.
No.
It was supposed to open up after Gonta's case, but because Rantaro was already dead, it was locked permanently. Thanks to Kibo, we were able to get inside.
But
knowing all that, how could Rantaro have recorded a video in this room?
That might be true, but shouldn't we check the video first?
Ah, yes, right. Whoa. Rantaro's the mastermind? Confirmed? I turned to the laptop once again, and with a trembling hand, I played the video.
I get that this is probably pretty confusing, seeing yourself like this. Guess I should start from the beginning. First things first, I am you. No tricks, no actors. It's you. The reason you don't remember recording this is because that memory was erased. Think of this video as a message from Rantaro before you lost your memory to the Rantaro after you lost your memory.
Ooh.
So, let's get to it then. The reason I recorded this footage. I won the right to a special perk for participating in the killing game.
Wait. What?
Part of that perk is this video message.
I don't get it.
Monokuma said he was gonna make some kind of puzzle for you. The fact that you're watching this means that you've solved it already.
I don't get it. What's going on?
You can't share this with anyone. If you catch Monokuma shooing anyone away from you, that's why. There's another part of this perk. Something you get at the start of the game. I bet you know what I'm talking about. Something you've had from the start. Yeah.
So...
now, I thought that if you were smart, you'd have used it to end the killing.
I don't know. He was given something at the beginning. His knowledge of the ultimate hunt? I don't know. Maybe that's not it.
But if you're watching this, that obviously didn't work out.
Nope, I don't get it.
Easy, huh?
So he got the key card to get into the thingamadoo? I don't know. I mean, he was the one who had an idea and he was trying to stop the killing game, right? Get it at all.
Now, Monokuma probably already told you this, but just in case, this killing game will continue until there are only two people left. Now, the important part of that rule is that... looks like they didn't want me saying that, huh?
I don't get it.
Guess you'll have to solve that little mystery, but hey, you're smart. I know you can do it.
Dude, Rantaro's dead. This is so sad. He was literally trying to... Oh, is he gonna get Bub's dad again?
Truth is, this isn't your first killing game.
What? Wait, who is Rantaro? Who did Katie kill?
You're the ultimate survivor. You survived the last killing game.
Is this, no, it can't be. I was gonna say, well, I don't wanna give any spoilers for number two. Unless it's from number one. I mean, unless Rentaro Amami is actually Makoto. Come on, Katie. Did you actually accidentally kill Makoto? What if Katie's the mastermind and she knew that Makoto, who Rentaro is Makoto, and that's, no, it could also, actually, it would be more likely to be Byakuya than Makoto, right? But she knew that he had a perk? I mean, I'm just saying that because he looks more like Byakuya than Makoto. But yeah, what if she is the mastermind? She knew that Rentaro had a perk and was able to stop the killing game with his perk of some kind. And that's why she killed him.
That's why you get this perk. Survivor perk.
Nice. Hey, that sounds pretty nice. I wish I had that.
It's not all fun and games.
Except he died instantly. This is so sad, dude. He was actually the most powerful character. Well, the second most powerful character, right behind yours truly. And then he just died. This is...
Anyone who finds out who you are is gonna come.
Why?
So watch your back. Trust me.
I don't get it. What is going on here?
Never forget. You wanted this killing game. So you have to win, no matter what.
Well, he's already lost. So... Too bad, so sad. Rentaro's video message has been added to the truthless section of your motto pad. Dude, this man came in all confident that he could win, and then he died immediately. This is the saddest timeline. What was this? This isn't the first killing game? A killing game that he wanted?
What's that mean?
Shuichi, what did all of that mean? Who was Rentaro Amami? Look, Rentaro Amami backwards is Imama Oratnar. That doesn't make any sense at all.
If I remember correctly,
he said he survived the last killing game, and that video is part of the survivor perk.
Then
he was the ultimate survivor, an expert at death games.
Why?
Then why did he die so quickly?
Remember
what he said?
Anyone who finds out who you are is going to come for you.
What's that mean?
The one that was coming for him. Was he talking about Katie?
No.
No, she didn't know Rentaro's identity. She thought he was the mastermind. Then who is the one that knew Rentaro's true identity?
Could it be...
The real mastermind would have known.
Then...
Yo, if Katie is actually the mastermind, that's actually insane. Yo, we held hands too. That's crazy. We held hands and then she went and killed Rentaro. Why you gotta do this to me? In other words, the mastermind hidden in this academy set up Rentaro to be killed.
Okay.
I believe so.
Well,
for now. He said that he wanted this killing game. Why would he want that? If he hadn't done such a stupid thing, he probably wouldn't have been killed. I mean, all I'm thinking is that we were saying we want to die like everyone else, and that's why we set up this killing game. We all wanted to die. And that's why this killing game was going on. Another killing game. Why was he even participating in the first place? What was the other killing game? Because the killing game is... There was another thing. Rentaro said his survivor perk had another part, right? What was that other part? He said he had it at the start of the game. But when we found his body...
If I remember correctly,
all he had on him was his room key and the monopad. And that monopad was the same student handbook we had.
Then
it might still be left in his dorm room. Yes, it could be. I never imagined Rentaro, the first victim, would come up again like this. Oh, more memories time. Again. It's happening. But flashback. Ooh. What's going on? Yo. We're actually being injected with so much knowledge right now. They're gonna regret this later. Whoa!
Yo, Shuichi! I heard you're finally gonna take part in the Gopher.
Who are these guys?
Yeah.
They're just classmate with numbers.
Are you okay? Are you sure you're not overdoing it? You're the one who's overdoing it. You should be resting at home.
What's going on?
No, I can't do that.
These people are giving up on life.
Hope Speak Academy is working hard to create an antivirus. Even if they do find a cure, the meteorites are still going to be a problem for us. Hey, man, don't look so sad. You're about to go on an adventure, right? Now that I think about it, 16 boys and girls going on a space trip together. You guys gonna do it?
Whoa.
What are you guys talking about?
Whoa, this is a PG channel. Can't be implying.
I heard there's some
can't be implying that kind of stuff.
I told you, don't look so sad. I don't know if I can stand it. I'd have to leave everyone behind.
You have to go. I'm begging you.
Look, apparently I went. I mean, I can't imagine what else this would be. Whoa, wait, whoa. Yeah.
You're our pride.
These are my friends, and they're probably all dead. This is getting real sad.
Yeah, you have to do it. For us. We're leaving everything to you.
If things get too rough, then just remember all the fun times we had together. So, don't give up. You're our hope.
Yeah.
Everyone's
hope. We are the ultimate hope. No, we're the ultra hope. We're beyond ultimate hope. Ah, that memory.
Why did I have to remember my friends now of all times?
This is Monokuma's doing. He made us remember this. But why? Why make us remember that? That memory is no cause for despair.
That's right. There's no way we can give up. I promised I'd do my best for them. So there's no way I can give up.
Okay.
So we're looking for the other part of Rentaro's survivor perk, right? Leave it to me. I'll check every nook and cranny of this room with my magic, of course.
Breathing hard, Himiko ran off. What does all this mean? What are lies? What is the truth? Alright, we got friendship power up. Alright, so we gotta go to Rentaro's room. Man, I really wish we could warp. Oh, shoot. Wait, I skipped all the dialogue. There's no time to be standing around. We only have until dawn to investigate. I need to inspect every inch and get as many clues as I can get. I should go there next. If Kiba destroys the door like last time, I should be able to get in there. Are you kidding me? What happened to Rentaro's room? Okay, fine. It looks like we're going to the basement. Sumugi.
Shuichi.
Ah, Shuichi, I finally found you.
Sumugi, what's wrong?
I was checking Kaito's research lab up on the 6th floor, but...
What is it?
Kiba's attack demolished a wall on the school and caused a new room to appear.
A new room?
Yeah, it's a really weird room, too. Anyway, come with me.
Sumugi spoke almost encouragingly, then walked on ahead. Oopsies. A weird room, huh? I can't ignore that. I suppose I have no choice. I'll go there later and head to the 6th floor right now. Alright, are there robots to fight off? No. Can we just... Is there a hole in the wall that I can go, or do I have to go all the way back downstairs? Oh, fooey. We gotta go all the way back downstairs, dude. I don't remember where the stairs are, if I'm gonna be completely honest. Here they are. Da-da-da-da-da. Am I sure I can't warp? Like, I'd really like to.
Dang it, man.
Four friendship power. The breakthrough there. That's crazy. Yes, I need to get through here. Move. Ooh, this take gonna take a bye. Whew. Hey, I mean, it's good for my thighs. That's all that matters, right? Alright, there's probably a robot in here. No, I pressed the wrong button.
Leave it to me, everyone.
Get him. Ha ha. He was no match for my Kibo cannon. I doubt there's going to be a robot on the stairs. So I'm just going to run up the stairs. Where's the hallway? Okay, here we go. What in the world is this? Yo, is everyone the mastermind? Kaito's a mastermind too? He had a secret room? A new room. It must be that. Right? This room's really weird, isn't it? I can't figure it out.
Okay.
I'll try looking around. Alright, here we go. I went through the large hole in the wall and stepped into the next room. Cold sleep room. What? This is... Hold on. I'm gonna save... Just in case I take too long and run out of time. Because that would be really sad. Or something bad happens. I just gotta make sure nothing bad happens. Right? This room's really weird, isn't it? I can't figure it out.
Could it be?
I suppose it's possible that... Oh boy, more memories. So we're all asleep in this room. Nobody's actually dying. Is that it? But then how are we asleep in this room? But then... I don't get it. Hold on. We'll figure it out. Through this memory, right? This will help, right? Another... What is it this time? Kablammo! Ooh. Okay. What's this?
Well then.
Let's begin then.
Wait.
Hold on, I'm not mentally prepared yet. Well, robots probably don't need to mentally prep themselves the way humans do. Actually, do robots even need to be put in cold sleep? I'm still a teenager, just like you all. I would feel lonely if I were the only one still awake.
But is it really okay? This will be my first time in cold sleep, so I'm just plain nervous.
It's a shame for all of us. But you know... It's a man's dream to leave Earth behind and travel across the stars.
Ew. What a careless guy.
Fucking moron!
A stupid idiot is more like it.
Hey, who you calling an idiot?
Oh, I guess maybe we're not still asleep in this room. This is just where we were asleep when we went to space.
Okay, break it up. We gotta be friends here, so don't start fighting with each other.
Friends, you say?
Yeah, that's right.
That's right. Wait, no, that's not her voice.
That's right, we're friends from here on out.
Even though you just met us and you don't even know what we're like?
Because... Well, the 16 of us are going to be here together from now on.
Yeah.
Might be hard, but let's try to take it one step at a time. We might fight at first, but we shouldn't forget about believing in each other.
Yeah, that's right.
We all went through such a difficult time, so I think we can all become good friends. Right, what do you say?
Going to agree. Going to want to be friends with everyone.
After we wake up from cold sleep, we'll have no choice but to live together.
So we all better get along.
We're already friends.
Oopsies.
Even Adua says that we're friends.
That sounds like a pain, but it's okay, I guess.
Hey, what about you?
Me? Yeah, of course.
Mm-hmm. I'm glad.
No matter how many times we fight, we smile in the end. That's what true friendship is. It'd be cool if we could be like that, all 16 of us.
Right.
Yes, I agree, as long as we leave the degenerate males out.
I think us guys should be included too.
All right.
Then, let's do it. It'll probably be a couple of years before we all see each other again. But let's all work together and do our best.
That's right.
Yes, because we are humanity's last hope.
Alright,
then let's all get some shut-eye. I'll see you guys later.
That was an interesting memory, but it... Oof. Okay, we're back in the present.
Oh,
These memories are taking a lot out of us. I remember now, this room is...
This was the room where we went into cold sleep.
Tsumugi, you remember too.
Okay.
This is the room where we were put into cold sleep for the Gopher Project. It's where the 16 of us first met.
But back then, we all said we'd work together. We promised we'd become friends. And now we're killing each other? Why did it have to end up like this?
This is Monokuma's fault. Monokuma, the true mastermind controlling him.
That real mastermind hiding in this academy is making us do all this, right?
Right.
Hey, Shuichi, let's find them no matter what and end the killing game for good. And then let's finally fulfill that promise we all made.
Alright, I just feel like there's no way the mastermind was one of the 16 students. I mean, unless it actually was Katie or Rentaro. I feel like Rentaro is less likely because... Like, I don't know. Again, it seems like with the same way Kokichi wasn't the mastermind. Too convenient, right? He's the mysterious guy, so he must be the mastermind, right? But no. Also, he's dead. I'm pretty sure he didn't fake that death. I'm pretty sure that would be kind of difficult. You know, survive getting hit on the head with a heavy metal ball like that.
There's a lot of us missing now, but it's not too late.
Yeah, you're right. We've got the power of friendship. I guess we gotta investigate this room. The documents. Alright, what do we got? There's some documents left on the table. A Gopher Project participant list.
Oh yeah, I wanted you to take a look at this. I found it when I was here earlier.
Anything of particular note?
All of our profiles are written here. Most of it is stuff we already know, but that's not the important part. It's about Katie.
What? What about Katie?
She has a twin.
A twin?
Yeah, it seems like she has a younger twin sister.
Hold up. What was Katie's last name? Akamatsu. Yeah, that's not giving me any hints.
It said her sister was adopted by a relative, but they barely had any contact. But I'm still a little worried because Junko Inoshima also had a twin sister.
Okay. True, but...
On top of that, Junko used her twin sister to run her killing game from behind the scenes. I mean, it's probably just a coincidence, but I thought I should mention it to you, Shuichi.
Thank you.
Yes, thank you. So what, Katie's twin sister is the mastermind? This is the first time I'm hearing that Katie has a twin. But is that relevant? It doesn't really matter, does it? Go for project participant list. Has been added to the truth bullet section of your monopad. Whoa, this place isn't gonna last for very long.
Their battle has gotten more intense. I wonder if we're gonna be okay. Seems like the building is gonna break soon.
Kibo said he'd give us until dawn, but...
But there's a chance that Monokuma will defeat Kibo before that, right?
Either way, we should hurry.
What are we gonna do now?
There's a place we should investigate. I found it right after the killing game started, but it's been closed this whole time.
You mean...
Yes, the hidden room in the back of the library. With Kibo's help, I'm positive I can get inside.
Oh, you're right. I'll go with you.
Yeah, Tsumugi, let's go. Friendship power up. Big friendship muscles. That's what we have. Would you like to leave? Yes. I still wish I could warp. You know, this is getting a little... You know, I'm happy that I'm working on my leg muscles and all, but, whew. I'm starting to get cramps. So we're right. Oh, what? Hold up. Yeah, you thought I didn't see that. Give me that. Let me. Oh my gosh, we're gonna run out of time. Give me that already. Boom. Give me that. Yeah. Hidden Monokuma is mine. Look, it may be the end of the world, but there's always time to get hidden Monokumas. Yo, bossies. How's it popping? Yep, chapter 6. This is the I don't know the right adjective. The heat of the moment. No, that's probably not what I meant to say. I mean, maybe it was what I meant to say. Is there a robot here? No. Is there a robot in the lobby? Now there is. Oh, you think you're hot, huh? Yeah, he's running away. He was like, oh, no, he's going to get Kibo in here. Bow, bow, bow.
blow that man away. Let's go.
Yeah, we have the power of friendship now. You just finished it a couple weeks ago? Sweet. Yeah, I'm probably not finishing it today. How do I get into the library? Here we go. I'm probably going to get up right until the trial. I assume there's going to be some sort of trial after this investigation. I'm probably going to do the trial tomorrow.
I knew you would come here. If you're investigating old areas, you'd have to come here eventually. But before you do, listen to what I have to say.
This is about the blueprints. Have you looked through all of them?
Yeah, I have, but something caught my eye that worried me. Although I'm not sure how significant it is.
Alright, tell me. Before we get in there, tell me. What do we got? Hey, Maki. What was in all those blueprints you were looking through?
I found a design that worried me a little. It was drawn with too much detail.
It looks like a vacuum. What a peculiar shape. What in the world is that?
It's a machine that sucks up bugs called the bug vac.
Is that why there's no bugs in here? Because they bug vacuumed it all up? Gonta is the mastermind confirmed, but that's probably not true. Huh? A bug vac?
Kokichi came up with the design, but I thought there weren't any bugs outside of Gonta's lab.
No.
Now that you mention it.
Oh, that cause of tiny bugs.
Bugs? I thought vermin were nowhere to be seen in this academy.
Yeah, going to think that before, but when out walking in courtyard, going to think he see tiny bug. But bug so tiny, even going to know could see it, and going to have 20.625 eyesight. So maybe going to just make mistake, but going to think. No, maybe going to just see things.
Remember,
going to was always seeing small bugs.
But going to said he was just seeing things.
Oh yeah.
Maybe Kokichi asked me to invent that to see for himself.
So Miu actually made this?
Okay. After I found this design, I went to Miu's research lab.
Well,
I found a prototype that she was still working on.
Hey.
This is it. It may be a prototype, but it seems to be functional already. The suction function is already finished.
As she said that, Maki flipped the switch on the machine and... Whoa, we're already... Okay. It has a pretty strong suction.
This, you can vacuum up all the bugs around you at once.
Nothing in it.
Yeah, it looks like it was used several times, but it doesn't seem like they caught any.
Maki sighed and turned off the bug catcher.
I see.
Then does that mean there are no bugs? It was just going to his imagination after all? That's probably the case. Well, even if there were bugs, I don't know how that would be a clue. But I wanted to tell you, especially since I spent a lot of time investigating it.
Okay. Right, thank you. Maybe we just can't see them. Maybe they're so small that our lame human eyes can't see them. And we're going to show it to Kibo, and Kibo's going to be like, there's bugs in there. What are you talking about? Were those bugs really just going to his imagination? There must be more to it than that. Oh, did I skip something? No, I didn't. Bug vac had been added to the truthful section of your monopad.
You guys were here? We were all gonna meet up. Why didn't anyone tell me? I couldn't find anyone, so I was starting to get worried.
Sorry.
Hey.
Where were you up till now?
Hey. You went to Rintaro's room, right? Did you find anything interesting? Oh, looks like she did. What is this expression? All right, Himiko, talk to me. Talk to me. Hey, Himiko, did you find anything in Rintaro's room?
I'm not going to tell you. Stop asking me. Shut up. Leave me alone.
Huh? Why?
If I say I didn't find anything, you're going to decide I'm useless, aren't you? I won't let that happen.
So I guess you didn't find anything.
Oh, she definitely did find something. I saw that expression.
Don't worry. I wasn't expecting anything from you anyway.
Whoa.
That's just as bad.
If it isn't in Rintaro's room, then where is his survivor perk? We didn't find anything on his body. Did he hide it somewhere before he died? Well, hiding it in your room would be the safest place for it. Did someone take it?
What's wrong?
Shuichi, what's wrong?
You're right.
Hey, we're going to check what's behind the hidden door, right? Let's hurry and do it.
Yeah, you're right. Yeah, let's go. The hidden door is where Rintaro was investigating just before he died. There might be something in there that would be a valuable clue. First, I should inspect the hidden door. Yo, we don't have a lot of time. A hidden door is revealed when the bookcase swings open. The door has been locked this entire time. Alright, Kibo, let's go. Let's keep go to the poles. Hilarious. With Kibo's help, we might be able to open it.
The door that can only be opened with a guard key. There must be something here.
Maybe the mastermind is hiding behind this door.
That's true.
Then if we kill them, we can end this killing game.
No.
No, I told you we can't kill them. If you do that, we'd be the same. What?
Huh?
Kibo? You there?
You guys have been doing whatever you feel like, huh? You can't just go anywhere you want without permission. Father will get mad.
Yo, you're about to get mad. You're gonna get mad because we're gonna... Look, imagine you switch in your Landorus to a Greninja, your scarf, and you have out your Toxapex, right? So you're like, oh, they're surely going for Dark Pulse, right? And you get pumped on the switch in, and you die. That's what's gonna happen to this guy. We're hydro pumping you on the switch in.
Damn it! Everyone run!
Bow!
I can't move.
Ho ho! Got him. Now we got a BM. GG, easy, nice. Thanks for free points. That's the kind of stuff I'm gonna say to this guy.
Just stay put.
Kibo, you saved us. As a reward, I'll use my magic to turn you into a real boy.
So you need me to open that door, right?
Yes, please. Are you ignoring me? Well, I guess there's nothing I can do since I need to charge my...
Please stand back. It's dangerous to be too close. After the terse comment, Kibo aimed his rocket launcher at the door. The hidden door is completely destroyed. So are the bookcases. I mean, why did we even move the bookcase if we're just gonna blow it up anyway?
Yes.
The door is open. We can finally enter. The mastermind's hiding in there. No doubt about it.
But it is is it okay if we just go in there? What if we get attacked or something?
Then we'll just have to strike back.
I would join you, but I need to hold off the exosols here.
Well then.
Shuichi, it's all up to you. Please catch the mastermind, no matter what. Okay, got it. Hey, you better be safe. We need your help to defeat the mastermind. You better not go dying on us. The mastermind is in here? That certainly is possible. We should be careful. Look, he's probably not in there, but something's in here. All right, let's go. And whatever's in here,
I'll go in first. I'm the only one who can fight if anything happens.
Whoa, what are you trying to say? Yo, I've been working out. It's part of my New Year's resolution. I've been lifting, bro. I bet I could take on the mastermind. If it came down to it, I bet I can beat him. Worst case scenario, I could beat him in a Yu-Gi-Oh battle. No, a Yu-Gi-Oh duel. That's what they call him. And if I win, he has to go to the Shadow Realm. That's just how Yu-Gi-Oh works, right? You just gotta, like, there. You don't have a choice in the matter. You have to go to the Shadow Realm if you lose a duel.
Oh, yeah, please.
Led by Maki, we walked through the hidden door. Dun dun dun. And what did we find? Excuse me? This doesn't look like a mastermind's lair. This just looks like a lounge. This is the hidden room. It's much bigger than I expected.
Wait. This room's atmosphere.
Seems like...
Doesn't it remind you of the remnants of despair that admired Junko and Oshima?
Does it? Not really.
What?
The mastermind behind this killing game must be hiding in here. Where? Where's the mastermind hiding?
Huh?
Was that Monokuma's voice just now?
Yahoo!
Welcome to the final stage. Guess it's time for the final boss to make their debut.
What?
Where's that voice coming from? Yo, he's not. There's no way the final boss is in here. No. We still have to get to the one place that's in behind the things that we need for people friendship powered. We're not done with the investigation yet. Alright, let's investigate. First, let's investigate. What's this? Nope, that's where we came from. Investigate the trash can. Is he hidden inside the trash can? Uh-oh, it's not good to ignore the final boss. I was prepared to offer you half the world if you joined me, but never mind. Are you kidding me? I thought you were hiding inside the trash can. Can you give me a break? Fine, he's in here. Whatever. There's something draped in fabric. It looks suspicious. I cautiously lifted up the fabric and... Okay, it's Monokuma. A Monokuma head. You found me, or rather, you just found a place that you were meant to find. At any rate, I can't end the killing game. The killing game that was born from the womb of despair. Starting with the killing game at Hope's Peak Academy, created by the Ultimate Despair, they're all connected. The killing game is despair itself. What is this? Yo, we're running out of time. Talk to me. Are you Monokuma? Of course, but I'm not just any Monokuma. I'm the overseer of the killing game and the source of all the Monokumas. So I've been given a special name, Mother Kuma. Mother Kuma. So then the machine that makes spare Monokumas in this academy. Oh, that's me. You see this amazing machine behind me? It creates spare Monokumas. All I gotta do is copy over my thoughts and presto, I give birth to myself. Huh, a spare Monokuma? Can they be made that easily? I thought they were advanced robots.
No way!
Oh yeah, that's why I'm so amazing. No, that might be a lie. It's trying to trick us with fake information.
Anyone can see this thing is giving too much information far too conveniently.
Huh? But it's not a lie. I can make spares really easily.
That's true.
Could you do that right now?
Yeah, try to make a new Monokuma. Huh? What's wrong?
Yeah. I can't birth a Monokuma for someone who doesn't love me. What about after it's born, huh? Did you think about that? Take some responsibility. Whatever. Just give birth to a Monokuma.
Birth refused.
No, I won't do it. I'm not gonna birth one for someone I don't like just because they tell me to.
Hurry up and give birth to a Monokuma.
Hey.
Are you listening? We said to give birth to a new Monokuma.
Hey.
It's totally ignoring us. I wonder if the thing about the spares was a lie after all.
A lie, huh? But why lie about that? There has to be some motivation to lie.
Mother Kuma has been added to the truthful section of your monopad.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, enough with this Mother Kuma. Let's hurry and search this room.
You're right, the mastermind is hiding in here somewhere.
Hey,
Shuichi, don't just stand around. Look for the mastermind.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's right. First, we have to see if the mastermind is hiding here. There should be other clues here as well. Okay, I mean, fine. Let's look at the trash can again. This is a trash can.
That's true.
I should investigate this too. I'm positive there's some clue here. I open the trash can casually and... Ah. I let out a surprised gasp.
What is this? This thing in the trash can is much heavier than I thought.
Why?
A shot put ball? Why is this here?
But there's no blood on this. It can't be the one that Katie used to kill Rentaro. In that case, where did this come from? Why is this here? Ah, this is... I noticed something sticking to the shot put ball. Some cloth fibers from something. So what I'm thinking is... No, that would be so sad. The mastermind looks exactly like Katie. Took the place of Katie. To murder Rentaro. And then executed Katie. That... would be the absolute saddest timeline ever. I don't know how I just got that. That was actually just my brain going into overdrive. Inspecting it closely, I can see several pink fibers stuck to the surface of the shot. They're pink. Wait, that means the shot. I understand. I know how to pin down the mastermind of this killing game. Shot put ball with pink fiber has been added to the truth bullet section of your monopad. Alright, what about this one? A monopad? And there's blood on it?
Why?
Whose monopad is this? And why is there a blood stain on it?
That's...
I don't know, but we should inspect it closely. If this is a student handbook, the name of the owner should be up when it turns on. Should show up. I started up the monopad and... This monopad is the survivor perk? Survivor perk. That means, in addition to the video, Rentaro's survivor perk was this other monopad.
No.
Is this a map of the Ultimate Academy? Whoa. Can I actually look at that? The places that open with the mysterious objects are labeled too, as well as the hidden room, which means this is a complete map of the Ultimate Academy for Gifted Juveniles. So Rentaro was given this map as part of his survivor perk. That's why he knew about the hidden door. Huh? What's this? Clue to end the killing game. A clue to end the killing game. The mastermind who is behind this killing game is hiding somewhere within the academy. The best chance of exposing them is when Monokuma needs a spare. At that time, the mastermind will go to the library's hidden room. To prove this hint is accurate, I will predict something. The first thing you will remember is the ultimate hunt. Only share this information with people you know you can trust. You can determine that will mean... How you determine that will mean your life or your death. Rentaro Amami. The mastermind who is behind the killing game is hiding somewhere within the academy. Your best chance of exposing them is when Monokuma needs a spare. Oh, I already read all that. I was actually reading off of the actual screen, but... Yeah, okay. There we go. A hint to yourself from yourself. That was part of the survivor perk. That's why Rentaro brought it up, because he read this hint. Hey, I have a question. This might sound a little weird, but does the term ultimate hunt ring a bell for anyone? This is exactly what Monokuma wants us to do. So what else is part of his plan? Is my memory part of it too? If it is, then... Can I even trust myself? Even he didn't completely believe it, but he had no choice. That's why he went to the library. That's what started all of this. Survivor perk monopad has been added to the truthfulness section of your monopad. That monopad isn't the student handbook. It looks like something else. But is that a bloodstain? Whose blood is it? I was going to check that. If I can determine whose blood this is, we'll be that much closer to the truth. How are you going to check? The camera Katie and I set up here. We can deduce it from the pictures.
I see.
That picture is in Kokichi's room. What? It is? That punk gathered evidence from the past cases just so he could. I bet he collected that picture too. So which one do you need? There were several pictures, right?
That's...
The last picture taken of Rentaro, the one in which he was trying to remove the camera. The one where the camera lured him with the flash.
Okay.
Got it. I'll go retrieve it. So I'll let you handle this area.
But...
Maki, be careful, okay? Kibo and the Exosols are fighting.
Hey,
who do you think I am?
You wanna die?
Okay. You know what? Fine. Kill me. I don't even care. I finally reached the point where I can tell that was a joke. What else am I supposed to investigate? Do I need to talk to Mother Kuma again? Look, I gotta save. I'm running out of time, dudes. Smoogie, talk to me. What are we missing?
And there's probably no doubt that the mastermind came here. There should definitely be a clue. Let's check thoroughly.
Didn't help. That took up time, you know. Give me a hint.
Where's the mastermind hiding? Please, Mother Kuma, may we ask you where the mastermind is hiding?
Why are you being so proper?
Ha,
I can't share information that important. It would make the killing game less exciting.
There's no doubt that this is the mastermind's room. It's definitely for the remnants of despair.
Oh, is it that obvious? Well, when you're right, you're right. The one you're all looking for comes to this room quite often.
Quite often?
But they're not stupid enough to let you guys catch them in the act.
And the mastermind isn't here.
If they come to this room frequently, then
I think my hint just finally dawned on Shirichi.
Hint?
Why?
Why are you giving us hints? Do you want us to find the truth?
Yeah.
What if I do? As long as it makes the killing game more entertaining, anything goes.
Even if it ends the killing game?
Huh? End the killing game? Oh, you haven't. Haven't I been saying it over and over again this whole time? The killing game is eternal! It doesn't matter what you do, this killing game will absolutely, positively never end. The killing game is a symbol of despair. How can something so fun just end?
What do you mean?
Oh, you don't need to fret over what it means. All meaning aside, it's the truth! The best thing you guys can do is just accept that truth.
Clues to the Mastermind has been added to the Truthful section of your mind.
Nice, level 60. Yo, we're running out of time. What else am I supposed to look at? There is nothing else in this room. Do I need to talk to Mother Kuma again?
Birth one? Acknowledge the ones that are yours before you make me birth another one.
I wonder if what is said about spares was really true.
Nope, that's nothing. Not helping.
There's nothing else to investigate. Maybe we gotta investigate the monopad again? This monopad. This was the monopad that Rentaro received as a survivor perk. The survivor perk monopad contains the map of the... And...
That's true.
Oh, wait. This is just wasting our time. Okay, yes, we already went through all this. Okay, hold on. We wasted too much time. We gotta go back to before we wasted all that time.
Sorry, dudes. We are running out of time in this thingamadoohicker. It seems like we run out of time. We lose time. Can I leave? There should be clues in this room. Do I gotta check the trash can again? Alright, what else is in here? There was a chocolate ball in the trash can, but there was no blood on it. It can't be the one that Katie used to kill Rentaro. Closely, I can see several pink fiber sectors. Man, how to pin down the mastermind of this killing game.
Nope, didn't help. What clues? What, do I gotta talk to Tsumugi again?
Nope. I gotta talk. I'm wasting so much time. Himiko, give me a hint. Nope, no hint. Wait. Oh, shoot. My bad. I forgot, I loaded up before I got that hint. Okay, we gotta go back, because we're losing so much time. Like, we barely have any time left in this time trial. Why is it a time trial? Alright, I already read through all this, so I'm just gonna get the clue. Real quick. Gonna save again, so I don't make that same mistake again. Can I leave yet? There still should be... Okay, fine. We're talking to Tsumugi again. Didn't help. What? Do I have to click on the half-broken door?
Oh, I guess I do. Hold on. Hold on. I want to... I'm so bad at this game. I'm sorry, guys. Look, when you put on a time limit, that's when things start to get rough. But I really don't have... I'm pretty sure I don't have any room to mess up here. My time limit's almost out. I examined too much stuff that I didn't need to. We were finally able to get in, thanks to Kiba destroying the hidden door. The only other way in was the key card. Of course, none of us have that, so we couldn't get in before. But it doesn't look like there's a card reader on the inside of the hidden door. I looked through the rubble but didn't find anything like that, which means you don't need a card key to leave this room. In that case, placing dust on that card reader wouldn't have mattered if they came from this side. Hidden door in the library has been added to the truthful section of your monopad. Alright, I finished up investigating everything I needed to. I can't believe that was it. I thought that was how I left. That's why I didn't investigate it. Yeah, what's going on? I can't find the mastermind anywhere.
They weren't hiding here. Did you find anything, Shuichi?
I've inspected everything I found, but I feel like there's still something hidden here. Oh, more memories. Again, another memory. What? This is...
Hey. Hiya, Shuichi. It looks like you've finally woken up from a long sleep.
What?
Monokuma? Although we're meeting for the first time, you already know me. Well, of course you know. I'm famous, after all. Hope's Peak Academy's Killing Game was the most watched event in television history.
Why is Monokuma here? It can't be!
Oh, but it can! This is where it all begins! A brand new killing game courtesy of the Gopher Project!
Killing game?
Now then, from here, things will proceed how they usually do. You'll all lose your memories and forget everything that's happened up to this point. The stakes of the Gopher Project, the hopes and dreams that humanity entrusted to you. Oh, and you'll forget that you're the last 16 survivors of the human race, too. The bonds of trust you forged, your disgusting promises of friendship. All that's gonna go bye-bye when the killing game starts.
What? Why are you doing this?
There's no point in asking me questions. You're gonna forget everything anyway.
Who's behind this? Who are you? Junko Inoshima is dead.
Like I said, there's no point. You'll just forget that too.
You're lying. How could I ever forget this?
Ta-da, the blackout light.
What?
The blackout light has the power to induce total memory loss. The light it emits stimulates the basal nuclei and hippocampus. Hey.
Wait a minute.
Nope, I'm not gonna wait. I'm gonna use this light when I'm gonna shove you all into lockers. Then I'm gonna shove you all into lockers while you're unconscious. And then the killing game will begin.
Okay. So we woke up in the middle of the trip, apparently. I remember. My final lost memory.
That was from just after we woke up from cold sleep.
Yes, a memory from right before the killing game began.
We were each woken up by Monokuma and our memories were taken. And we were forced to do all this.
We were going to work together. We promised to become friends.
Monokuma, I'll never forgive you.
Me too. I'll absolutely never forgive him.
I feel the same way, but right now we need to investigate. Dawn is coming.
Then leave things here to me. You go check all the other places.
Huh? What?
I feel there's still a mystery here, right, Shuichi? Then I'll find it for you. We're all trying to work together and find the truth, but I haven't found any clues yet. I need to recover my honor.
Himiko, will you be okay by yourself?
That's a stupid question. Since I got that memory back, I'm now overwhelmed with anger. With my skills, I'll catch that dastardly Monokuma and the mastermind.
I understand, then I'll leave it to you, Himiko.
Wait, really? Are you seriously going to leave it to me all by myself?
What should we do?
If you're not confident enough to do it, then you don't need to force yourself.
No. I am okay. Since you believe in me, I need to give it my all.
Okay.
I'll
find the clue, even if he uses up every last drop of my magic and kills me. Don't say such unlucky things. I'm just letting you know how determined I am. You guys should believe in me and go on ahead.
Thank you. That really makes me feel better, Himiko.
What should we do?
With how little time is left, it's probably best to split up, right?
Yes, we need to split up and check all the labs one more time. If we missed a clue in any of them, it would most likely be that one.
Got it, let's go.
Be careful.
You too, Himiko. I'm guessing he's talking about the ultimate pianist lab, because that lab is hidden behind rubble. When we left the hidden rooms, we saw Kibo and the Exosol in a fierce battle. A, it's hidden behind rubble, and B, her twin, right? Who I'm guessing is the mastermind, right? Oh. Got him. Are you alright? Are either of you injured? I'm okay. What? The hidden door has been blocked by rubble. Himiko. Alright, I guess we gotta talk to Kibo. I'm sorry. I'm relieved that you two are not hurt. That used up time? What am I supposed to do? I gotta look at the hidden room. Oh my gosh. The hidden door has been blocked by rubble. We can't get in or out.
Is Himiko trapped?
I think so. Can you do something? I can destroy the debris, but without knowing Himiko's status, it could be dangerous for me to just recklessly attack it.
Then are we? You're saying we should just leave her there? I could do such a thing. We're friends.
But I'm not strong enough to lift the debris. Let's use the Exosol.
What?
Use the Exosol? How?
We
don't have any more of Mew's inventions, and the Monocubs are in the Exosols.
Exactly. We're going to get the Monokuma and the Monocubs to do it. Monokuma and the Monocubs. They don't want this either. Their objective is to continue the killing game. Are you suggesting that we surrender to them and continue the killing game?
But Himiko's in danger. Rescuing her should be our first.
No, we're going to end this killing game. What do you mean? Do you have a plan of some sort? Okay. Yes, I do. It just requires a little bit of detective work. We need to investigate some more.
What about Himiko?
I'm worried about her, but we have to trust that she's okay right now. We trusted her when she said to leave everything to her. If we just stand around here, we're not respecting her wishes.
Himiko is the ultimate magician. I bet she'll use her magic to find a clue in that room. That's just plain amazing.
Okay. Yeah, I'm sure Himiko is okay. If you're in search of clues, I would investigate the classroom on the second floor. I caught a glimpse of something odd there while battling the Exosol in the courtyard. Whatever clue you're looking for may be there. Something odd. Just hurry, you don't have much time. It's nearly dawn. And I'm worried about Himiko. Kibo.
But you won't change the time limit, will you?
I can't keep evading the Exosol attacks beyond the time limit. If we don't settle this soon, I'll be destroyed. And if that happens, we'll lose the chance to destroy the Ultimate Academy. That would be the worst ending. No, it would be an ending of pure despair. Kibo.
Hey.
Tsumugi, I'm going to the second floor.
I don't know if I can get to all of them, but I'll do what I can. I'll see you later.
With confident steps, Tsumugi ran out of the library. Himiko just a little longer. Boom, friendship power up. Alright, we gotta go. We're running out of time. We gotta go fast like Sonic X. No Exosol wants to stand in my way. Yo, I don't even need the help from Kibo to blast away some Exosols. I'll blow you away with my fist. All that training with Kaito wasn't for nothing. He said the classroom, but which classroom? Can I look at the map? No, I'm gonna save real quick. Oh, please tell me I have enough time. I should be saving in different slots in case I need to go back.
This is the classroom we started in, right? No, in the back, this one. Okay, whew, thank goodness you didn't let me waste time. What is this? Kiba said that he saw something odd while fighting in the courtyard. I should be able to see the entire courtyard from here. This must be what he's talking about. Alright, let's see if I can find something. The locker? Is that it? This is the odd thing? The locker seems intact, but I don't think this is what Kiba was talking about. Dang it, man! Okay, oops. Okay, we're going back to where? Okay. But what is it? Oh, nice. I get a lot more time now. Ha! Aha! I can't... I didn't know that. The only other thing to investigate here is the door, right? Oh! Haha, I know what he's talking about. Move! I forgot I had this power, I'm gonna be honest. I forgot I had the power to push stuff around. Hey, push this desk aside too. Alright. Hologram display. What is this desk? There's a keyboard floating above it. Is this connected to a computer? This must be the something odd Kiba was talking about. When I touch the keyboard... Huh? Flashback light setup? Huh? Setup? Like settings? Seeking answer, I press the enter key. Hello, Game Master. World's End and the Gopher Project. That's it. Unlocking new memory. Do these settings create new flashback lights? To test my detection, I select one of the categories. I guess anyone will do. I'm just gonna do the ultimate talent. Oh. I guess I have to do this one. Select the subject you wish to remember. The survivors. So there are still some memories we haven't remembered yet. If we can remember something new, that would definitely be a clue.
Alright,
let's try it. What kind of memory it is? I'll start with the survivors. Oh, so you're just telling us where to start. Okay, fine. Be that way. Huh? Select the subject you wish to remember. What does it mean by select? These are all memories we forgot. All of these should be true events, so why would you be able to select one? In these categories, there are several inconsistencies about the survivors. Do I have to select the correct one?
That's true.
I suppose I'll choose the survivors on a different planet. If that's true, there's more hope for us. Symbol of Hope, Hope Street Academy. The worst incident in human history occurred with the work of... Future Foundation of the world was rebuilt, but falling meteorites caused an outbreak of an unknown virus. The Gopher Project was then executed. 16 high schoolers survived. However, there were survivors on other planets. There were survivors in other ships similar to the Ark. I suppose I meant to select yes here. Alright, I'll press it. Clonk.
Huh?
That sound.
If I remember correctly,
it came from that locker. So they built us fake memories. All these memories are fake.
If I remember correctly,
the sound I heard definitely came from the inside. Well, maybe. Maybe some of them are real, maybe some of them are fake. So we have no idea. I'll open it. A flashback light? This is new. It just got here. Just as I suspected, you can make flashback lights with that desk.
I don't know why it was hidden in a normal-looking classroom. But there must be a switch hidden somewhere. Flipping that switch will cause this desk to activate. I'm sure Kiba saw all this when the room was destroyed. What interests me is exactly how these flashback lights are made. There's only one truth. There should be only one true memory. Oops. I held down A on accident. But this clearly allows you to choose. Why? And there's no indication of which is real. Is there more than one truth? What is the truth? And what are the lies? Flashback-like settings has been added to the truth plus section of your motto pad. Right. At this moment, the classroom door suddenly burst open. Whoosh.
There you are, Shuichi.
Here you go. Alright. Oh, the classroom changed back to normal. So when the door opens, the classroom reverts back to normal. I can assume that was done on purpose to obfuscate the room's purpose. The person operating all this did not want us to see it. And if they're that cautious of us, Clues to the Masked Man has been updated in the truthful section of your mod pad.
Hey, Shuichi.
I don't know what you're thinking, Shuichi, but hey. I'm happier that I survived. I was able to make a spectacular escape from that sealed room.
Oh. Alright. How did Himiko escape when the entrance was blocked by rubble? Well, I guess she's about to tell us. Himiko, how did you get out of the hidden room? The hidden door in the library was destroyed. We were so worried about you. You were trapped in there.
You don't understand how I escaped from there?
No.
I see. You don't get it. You don't know how I escaped. Then I shall tell you. I escaped from the sealed room with my magic.
Himiko, now is not the time for... Yeah, we're about to die. Himiko, are you okay?
That was a close one. I almost died.
Remember.
I told you, now's not the time. Got it, I'll tell you. I definitely used my magic, but another thing that helped me escape that sealed room was the girls' bathroom on the first floor of the school building.
Huh?
The bathroom?
Hey,
do you want to go there with me?
Stop
I'm not inviting you to go to the bathroom with me. Just don't start getting weird thoughts. No,
I know that. The girls' bathroom on the first floor. What did that have to do with the hidden room? There doesn't appear to be any new clues other than the flashback light. Alright, I'll head to the bathroom. Alright, we gotta run. We gotta go. Even though we got some extra time because I'm bad at this game. We didn't get a bunch of extra time, so we gotta go. Oh, nice. The bathroom is right here. Alright, let's just go. Look at me in the girls' bathroom. Keep outside. I'm a boy. I should ask you first. Are you kidding me? Just let me inside, dude. There's no lock on the door. Just let me inside. What is going on in this bathroom? Does it have something to do with the hidden room?
Once you go in, you'll understand. Seeing is believing. Follow me.
Can you go gesture me closer and walk into the girls' bathroom? Girls' bathroom, huh? Okay, let's just go. Let's just go. We don't have time. We don't have time to lollygag and mess around. This is an emergency. Nothing I can do about that. Not the time to be thinking about boys and girls bathrooms. All right, I'll do it. I repeated several excuses in my mind as I stepped into the girls bathroom. Look, legit, there's nothing inappropriate in there right now. Everyone's dead except for, like, Himiko. Right? So obviously, you're not going to see, like, what you think you're going to see in there. What are we doing in here, Himiko?
So it looks like the Killing Game in Hope's Peak Academy.
What do you mean?
It's just like then, right? The hidden room and the bathroom are connected.
The hidden room and the bathroom?
Look where the equipment is placed. Jeez. Caught up on past Killing Games. That's typical of a remnant of despair.
What? I know you're talking about that, but I don't... Hold on, I want to pull up this. Oh, okay. I thought she was talking about herself or me, and I'm like, so one of us is the mastermind, huh? But then I'm like, oh, no. This school was designed to be like Hope's Peak Academy from the first game. The Remnant of Despair, who made this Killing Game, made it like that. I get it. Okay. Boom.
This looks like a normal closet, but I carefully place my palm on the far wall of the closet. Bang. A hidden passage.
Isn't it surprising? A hidden pathway deep within the bathroom. Now proceed through this pathway.
Yeah, let's go. I step through the false wall and into the hidden passageway. Down the stairs we go. Let me guess, it's just going to lead to the hidden room behind the bookcase. Why is it so long? Ha ha ha. Is there anything behind us, like a hidden Monokuma? No? Of course not. This would be the perfect place for a hidden Monokuma. I can't believe it. That's pretty late. But oh well, you know what? That's fine. Oh, what? It is broken. What happened? It leads to the hidden room. The girls' bathroom and the hidden room in the library are connected. The library isn't the only way to get in and out of the hidden room. The hidden room had this secret passageway leading out of it. And that passageway connects to the girls' bathroom on the first floor. But this passageway wasn't on Rintaro's survivor perk map. The passageway was hidden, even from him. A hidden passageway that only the mastermind knows about. A passageway connected to the girls' bathroom. Hidden room passageway has been added to the truth bullet section of your monopad. Now what? Look at my gear broken. What's up with this? Mother Kuma's lying on the ground, likely due to the explosion. Is it broken?
I'm busted.
It's over.
It's over. I can't go on. I can't birth Monokumas anymore. I wanted to birth more and more and more.
Birth Monokumas, huh?
Hey,
is it true that you can make spare Monokumas?
Yeah.
Of course it's true.
Fine, since this is the end for me, I guess I'll say it. I have a built-in voice print authentication system.
I can't birth Monokumas unless the designated person specifically says the word birth.
Designated here. Person.
That's to ensure that my Monokumas are birthed into a welcoming environment, you know?
Hey. Wait a minute, this designated person, do you mean the mastermind? Only the mastermind's voice command will make you create a spare Monokuma?
That hint was on the house, so to speak. All the glory to the Killing Gleam!
Rest in peace, Mother Kuma. Hey.
It seems like it's really broken this time.
That was an important clue. Mother Kuma creates spare Monokumas after receiving the Mastermind's voice command.
Whoa, why isn't that a truth bullet? Hello?
Alright, you can go talk to me. Once more, I shall reveal the secret behind my escape in the shield room. Yes, please do. Right after you guys left this room, there was a huge explosion and I got flipped over. When I came to my senses, it looked like this. I'm surprised you weren't hurt. Since I've been using my magic a lot lately, a magical backlash must have happened. And the way the out got buried in rubble. Even I, the wise and powerful Himiko, panicked a little bit when I saw I was trapped in here.
What happened after that?
I banged on the walls, the floor, and yelled for help, calmly and rationally, of course.
I'm sure.
Then I happened to find that hidden pathway. That's how I got out.
Okay.
Then I ran into Kibo, and he told me you were in one of the classrooms on the second floor. So I rushed over there. I see. So that's what happened. I understand now.
Hey.
Well, was I useful?
Seems Himiko is still concerned about that. I should probably get out of here. If the entrance to the bathroom were blocked by rubble, we'd be completely trapped. Himiko, let's go. I have a good idea of what's going on here.
Hey.
Something wrong?
Hey.
Just tell it to me straight, like a man.
Huh? Tell you what?
The hidden pathway I found, is it a useful clue? I want to be useful for my friends. But I can't help much in investigations, can I? I couldn't find the mastermind.
You're worried about that?
Okay.
Himiko, not only were you useful, you may have cracked the case wide open.
I see.
Really? If I found such an amazing clue, that's proof I'm no ordinary person. I'm terrified of my own magical power.
Right, let's get out of here. Yeah, that's a good idea. Let's find a clue.
and that it led us here. There's nothing to check there. What do you mean? How do I get out of here?
I literally have to press B. I can't just click on the exit. Okay, that's fine. I mean, okay, sure. Why not?
I don't have a mini map of this place, so I gotta turn manually to see where I'm going. Let me out of here. Bang!
Let me out! Let me out!
We've come this far. We're safe. Now that I feel safe, I'm a little over it.
Ah, okay. I'll step outside. Blushing, I left the girls' bathroom as fast as I could. Hey, Shad Starzik. Welcome to the stream again.
Not really. My guess is that Katie's evil twin is the mastermind, but I mean, we've gotten that's pretty much all I can deduct. If that's even true, maybe Katie was actually the mastermind and her evil twin is like actually not evil and she was actually evil. I don't even know. Anyway, we gotta we gotta keep going. At that moment. So if you're worried, I'm not actually going to do the trial today as well. So I'll probably get this uploaded. I'll try my best to get this uploaded to YouTube. Well, actually, you can just watch the VOD on Twitch, so you don't even need to wait for it to be uploaded to YouTube. But yeah, I'm definitely going to have this uploaded to YouTube by the time I stream. But hopefully, you can catch up with everything on the VOD. And I'm going to stream the trial tomorrow. That is the plan at the moment.
Huh?
What were you doing? Why were you in the girls' bathroom?
Maki is not what it looks like. I'm just...
Do you want to die?
No, listen, there's a reason. Look. Big clue. Let me tell you. Big clue. Look. It was actually Himiko's big brain.
What? Don't do that when I'm doing my business.
Oh, I'm about to walk right into it. Is it soon? I mean, that's fine. The thing is, it's pretty late. It's almost 9 p.m. where I live. So I don't... And the trial's probably going to be like 5 hours. So I'd probably get finished at like 2 a.m. And I really don't want to stay up that late, if I'm being completely honest. Even though I could, not only do I not want to stay up that late, I don't think anyone else really does either. So in order to make it a more accessible stream, I'm probably just going to do it tomorrow. So, yeah, it's going to be a short stream today, but that's okay. I think it's okay to have a short stream every once in a while. Besides, we're learning. We're expanding our IQ. We're increasing our IQ today. Before we use that increased IQ to blow the mastermind all the way back.
I can't relieve myself if you do that. Himiko's inside, and you were... In there, Shuichi?
Maki is not what it looks like. It's not what it looks like. I would never do that with a low-tier girl. Never, ever. Okay, this is all a huge misunderstanding.
Well, I guess you wouldn't... I guess you wouldn't enter the girl's bathroom without a reason. I'll believe you.
She doesn't look like she believes
me.
Thank you. Though it still seems like you want to murder me. She's mad. Yo, Himiko, you gotta tell her. It wasn't what it looks like. Come on. Let's clear things up.
Anyway, I found this.
Rentaro's picture. Thank you. I took the photograph from her and inspected it closely. Just as I thought, I sighed to myself, looking over the picture. I mean, what we can see from this picture is that he was holding his monopad when he went to get the camera, which means he was holding his monopad when he got hit on the head, bonk. And that means the blood on the monopad is his, but it was his monopad, so wouldn't it make sense? I don't know. I feel like this isn't as big of a clue as I want it to be. Everything was beginning to connect in my mind. Well, I guess Shuichi's smarter than me, then. I mean, he is the ultimate detective. I finally saw through all of the lies. Final picture of Rentaro has been added to the truthful section of your monopad. Maybe Rentaro is actually the ultimate imposter from the second game. Who knows? With this, I can fight.
I can fight the mastermind behind this killing game, and I believe I can end it all.
Hey. You look like you just realized something.
Well,
what do you want to do now? It's almost dawn.
This is bad. We don't even know the mastermind's identity or where they are.
It's okay, I have a plan. Can you two please go get Tsumugi? She should be in one of the labs. After that, I'd like everyone to gather in the courtyard. I'll be waiting for you there.
What do you mean? What are you planning on doing?
Stopping the killing game, of course. Yeah. Don't worry, it should be, I don't know if you have, like, work or school tomorrow or anything like that. But I don't think I'll start it too early. I don't want it to be too late either, right? Because I started this stream pretty late, which is why we're ending so late, even though it's a short stream. But I'll probably start maybe around... Oh, I don't know. I mean, if you have a time... I don't know what time... Oh, shoot, I disconnected my controller. Can't continue the game without the controller. I was thinking about sometime in between noon and 2 p.m., since, because I'm expecting the trial to take about 5 hours, so that should get me done around like 5 to 7, which I think is a good time to end it. That'll give me time to get like the VOD uploaded to YouTube and everything and whatnot. After I finish the stream. So I was thinking, but if like that's too early, then I can push it back just a little bit. I'm sure it wouldn't be too big of a problem. But that's the plan at the moment. If you need to have an idea of what time it's going to be, probably sometime around there.
But we haven't even found the mastermind, so how...
We can talk about that later. We don't have much time left, so let's hurry and find Tsumugi.
Oh, I see.
Yeah, go find Tsumugi. I stood and watched Himiko and Maki go off to find Tsumugi.
All right,
to the courtyard, but before I stop this killing game, I need to stop the destruction of the Ultimate Academy. Yeah, we gotta get Kibo. Quickly. Oh, where is he? We gotta get outside. Nice, we're level 61. Yo, we're big levels out here.
Whoa, this is taking a while to load. What's going on outside?
When I stepped out in the courtyard, I yelled at the top of my voice. Kibo Monokuma, please stop fighting! We can solve this another way, one that's best for both of you. Please listen to me. My voice reverberated throughout the courtyard. After a while, they both heard me.
It's almost dawn, like we agreed. Have you found what you were looking for? Are you ready to do what must be done, Shuichi?
All right, sweet. That should work for me. I mean, I don't have work tomorrow, which is why I'm able to stream tonight. I mean, technically, I'd be... Well, no. Like, I don't like to stream when I feel like I have a time limit, right? So when I stream on night... If I have to work the morning shift the next day, I usually don't like to stream that night because it means I have to stop at a time where I can actually get to bed and get enough sleep so I can wake up in the morning to get to work on time. Because I'll tell you right now, I actually had to rush outside to get to work on time. I barely had enough time to, like... get everything done, like eat breakfast and brush my teeth and all that stuff. I was like running out the door to get to work on time. So yeah, I need to manage my time better. I'm not that great at it. I'm getting better. I'm just still not good at it. So practice makes perfect, right?
Either way, this is your last chance.
Don't worry.
I have no idea what's going on, but messing with this robot is starting to bore me. So I guess I'll hear you out.
So what is this other way?
The way around we've been doing all this time. We're gonna class trial it up.
Class trial.
Hey.
One last time.
Yeah, let's go.
Class trial?
You already know, dog. See, that got their attention. What do you mean? Are you trying to continue the killing game? This is no time to mess around. I thought you were going to end it.
No.
I'm not messing around.
That's wrong.
The class trial will end the killing game.
Huh?
A class trial to end the killing game? As Kiba spoke, I saw Maki running over from the school building. Whoa, where's the movie? Oh, she's with everyone, of course.
What are you talking about?
Hey, what do you mean we're going to do a class trial?
Are you serious?
That's how you're going to end the killing game?
Okay.
Everyone's here. Now, let me say this. We need to stop fighting and have one more class trial.
That's it.
If we reveal the whole truth there, we can end this killing game.
The killing game will end when the truth is exposed. Why would you say such a thing?
By the end of the class trial, that will be clear. Monokuma, you're the one who calls these class trials. But not this time. This time, we choose to call a class trial. One to end them all. Oh yeah, Shuichi's gone full-blown alpha male. He's calling the shots now. He's Shuichi Prime now. Let's go.
But why do we need to hold a class trial when no one has been killed? That's what I'd like to say, but I get it.
What?
My little shootout with this rundown robot hasn't been fun for a while now. And I think it's pretty interesting that you guys are on board with holding a class trial. In fact, I welcome your initiative. This turn of events will make things very interesting.
So even in these circumstances, you take the opportunity to make things interesting. That means, oops, don't skip dialogue. This killing game must be.
However, if we're gonna hold a class trial, I'm gonna hold you guys responsible for it.
Responsible?
It would be bad if we held a class trial that didn't reach a satisfying conclusion. In other words, if the trial doesn't go your way and ends without the truth being exposed, then you all will be held responsible for staging such a disappointing class trial.
Of course.
I don't doubt your resolve at all. But are the others okay with it too? The responsibility will be shared by all of you.
What was that?
The responsibility will be shared.
We've been ready.
That's true.
I'll trust you. But if you screw this up, I'll kill you before Monokuma can.
Well, doesn't look like... she's probably going to kill me anyway. She's probably still mad about that whole misunderstanding in the bathroom. Not going to lie. Hey, Kibo, you on board?
Yeah, I believe you.
Right.
That was sarcasm.
You're right. There's no point freaking out now. I have friends I can trust. There's nothing to be scared of.
Kibo?
Also, if we're gonna do this class trial, you gotta take off all the fancy sci-fi gear. We can't risk you going berserk and the outcome isn't in your favor.
Take off this gear. If I remove these armaments now, I will lose my chance to destroy this academy. This is the last chance. The last chance to not let Monokuma win. Is this really alright?
Kibo, please believe me. I don't want Monokuma to win. We're going to win. Our hope is going to end this game of despair.
Do you really think that ending awaits us? It sounds too good to be true, honestly.
Yes, I do. That ending is hope for us, and we can't give up on hope.
Kibo, let's trust Shuichi here.
You don't want to die either, right?
We're all friends who can believe in each other, aren't we?
I understand.
Very well, I remove my armaments. Let's hold this class trial.
Thank you, Kibo.
Then it's decided.
That's right, our class trial, our final battle, our hope will defeat your despair.
He's excited. What? I'm excited. Why are you laughing?
Is he confident that he'll win?
It'll be okay. He's probably just bluffing.
Who can say? Well, if we're gonna do this class trial, we should hurry up and head to the trial grounds. However, I will have the Mono Cub strip that robot of his gear.
Yeah.
I know.
Everyone else, please proceed to the Shrine of Judgment and head to the trial grounds. I'll go on ahead and begin preparing. Mono Cubs, you can take it from here.
Alright, let's go.
Alright then, we're gonna take all this gear off of this robot.
I'll finish it in seconds, cause I work like I eat, fast and sloppy.
You shouldn't be proud of being sloppy.
Everyone.
I'll meet you guys there.
Yeah. Oops, I skipped dialogue. Kibo walked back towards his lab with the exosols. We should go too.
I can't believe we're having another class trial.
Why?
I didn't think Monokuma would accept so easily. That was too easy. I can't help but feel a little strange. He probably agreed to it to stop Kibo from destroying the academy.
Still, it was almost too easy. Perhaps Monokuma simply expected this? But it was still much easier than I imagined it would be. No sense worrying about that now. We've come this far. We just have to do it. To end this killing game, we have to follow his rules one last time and win this class trial. Hey, I've never lost a class trial. A+ is all the way. Here we go. Let me show you.
Let me show you just how many A pluses I can get, but not today, tomorrow, because we're going to do the class trial tomorrow. But before we do that, before we finish up, we're obviously just going to, you know, get all the way to the trial grounds. Oh my god, it's all broken. The next time we come out of the trial grounds, it'll be all over, right? We can win, right?
Okay.
Of course. Okay. It'll be okay. This class trial should be much easier than the others. Why?
Because.
Up until now, we had to find the culprit among the people in our group during the class trials. That's why we couldn't work together, even if we wanted to, but this time it's different.
I see.
Since there isn't a culprit among us, we can work together without any doubt. We're all going to be working together this time. I already feel more at ease. Why am I silent? Is the culprit really one of us? Oh no, please don't tell me that the culprit is one of us. Ah, really? There's no way, right? But I wish it had happened sooner. At the beginning, there were 16 of us. I mean, hold on. There's pink pieces of fabric. Wait. No, I don't get it. But now there's only 4 of us standing here plus Kibo, who's coming later. We're about to head to the last battle. Why are you so depressed? Oh, sorry. You're right. Like, nobody... I was gonna say nobody has pink hair. Right? Nobody has pink hair, right? That's purple hair. I doubt his hair is pink. He has purple hair, not pink hair. Yeah, nobody here has pink hair. I guess Miyu wears pink a lot, but her hair wasn't pink, right? Katie had blonde hair. Alright, no, I'm just not going to try to make predictions about who the mastermind is. We'll figure it out tomorrow, because, I mean, Shuichi apparently already knows, but I guess I'm not as smart as him. Thank you, Wolf, for waiting.
Kibo.
That was fast, Kibo. His weapons have been removed. I suppose we don't have to worry about him attacking. What? Are you disappointed? Did you prefer your sci-fi gear after all? No, it's not that.
Everyone.
I'm just very sorry. He attached his antenna again. He's back. His hope is back. This is real, Kibo. Kibo bowed at the waist to us. I acted recklessly and put you all in serious danger.
Everyone.
I'm sorry. I'm very, very sorry.
What?
What's wrong? You're totally different from before when you were in battle mode. Shuichi, you told me earlier not to give up on hope.
Okay.
That's right. I finally realized that you were right. My inner voice told me. Okay. Your inner voice? I thought you said you couldn't hear it anymore. Well, I had the Mono Cubs prepare me in addition to removing my battle gear. And now, for some reason, I can hear my inner voice again. So he can hear it again after the repairs. But it looks like his hair looks like an antenna. Does that mean it wasn't just decoration? And now that I think about it, what is his inner voice exactly? What does he hear? I was wrong to try to destroy everything just to avoid losing to despair. Even if I had followed through, there would have been no hope or future left afterwards. In which case, my actions would have merely resulted in a different despair altogether. I do not expect for you to forgive me. What I did was foolish. But I will allow... Will you allow me to fight alongside you? I want to help you with... Find the truth. Please! Of course, Kibo. That's what I've wanted from the start. Exactly. Kibo, my man, dude. Me and Kibo, we even got a secret handshake. We're like, bow, 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 bow. We're bros. If it wasn't for you, we wouldn't have been able to do this. So, you'll allow me? Oh, you seem angry, Sumugi. Would you prefer I not help? I'm not mad. I'm just holding myself back. When someone says please that strongly, I always want to respond with, but I refuse. But I can read the mood here, so I'm holding back. Well, of course. Yeah, I'm okay now. Of course you can fight with us, Kibo. There's a big wall living between living things and objects, but you're our friend, Kibo.
Everyone.
Thank you. Boom. By the way, Maki, I've been meaning to ask you, but what is that vacuum cleaner you're carrying?
I see.
It's the bug vac. I think Okichi designed it and had Miyu make it.
I see.
Ah, yes. Gonta had mentioned something about tiny bugs before. Yes, I thought it could be a clue to something. But we can't seem to catch any bugs with it. It doesn't seem like there are any. So it really was just Gonta's imagination after all.
No.
Wait, it might be too soon to determine that.
Can we wait until I've examined it with my eyes at least? Your eyes. Alright, Kibo. How small are these bugs? And what do they look like? What do you mean, Kibo?
What good can your eyes do? It's not like you've got good eyesight, right?
Yeah.
That was true until I installed my zoom function.
Huh? Your zoom function?
Yes.
It was in my lab next to the jetpack and rocket launcher. Thanks to that zoom function, my vision has increased 100-fold.
Huh?
100-fold?
That's a power-up that goes way past your default settings.
This is the true talent of the ultimate robot. Because I'm a robot, I can evolve in ways that are simply not possible for a human. I've finally accepted that. There are notable differences between us, but they're nothing for me to be ashamed of. Because with my talent, it's possible that I can save you all. Kibo took the bug back from Maki and... It's worth a shot. At maximum zoom, my vision is on par with that of a microscope. Maki, I'll borrow this bug back for a moment. He stared at it intensely. Alright, what does he see?
I'll print out this memory.
Yes, show us. Oh, they're little Monokuma bugs. I saw it too. Just as before, Kibo printed a picture from his right out of his mouth. He took it from his lips and handed it to me.
Huh?
Is this Monokuma? The little bugs have cameras. Oh my goodness. What is this?
Hey.
Are these the small bugs Gonta was talking about?
Yes.
A human's eyes would not be able to see things that exist at a nanoscopic level.
You're going to have noticed them. His vision really was superhuman.
Hey,
what are these things holding? Are they holding cameras?
Well,
why don't we ask them? We can talk to this?
To me.
Yes, I have already installed an augmented hearing function.
What was that?
I guess anything is possible.
Start talking now. One by one.
Hey, you want to die? You better start talking.
Whatever function you serve, you'll be unable to carry it out. Do you accept these terms?
Kibo asked in a way that made it clear it was not up for negotiation.
They call themselves Nanokumas. Apparently, they're members of the Monokumas.
Okay.
What? This little thing?
Then there were actually six Monokumas?
Not quite. These don't exist as individuals, but rather as a hive mind.
Oh.
They travel through the air in a swarm, covering every square inch of this campus.
So it's not just one, it's a whole swarm of Monokubs.
Yeah, that does sound pretty gross.
Ew.
I don't like the thought of that.
And their function is to record footage of the events that are unfolding here. And transmit it to Monokuma. What?
So that's how he knew everything at every time. Because he had cameras literally everywhere, even places
using
without cameras.
Cameras. They record footage and transmit it wirelessly.
Wait, then how did he not know who the victim was in the last trial? I guess there were no Monokubs in that room. Maybe that's why the bug vac was used. Kokichi used the bug vac in that, room to suck all the bugs out, and so they couldn't send information to Monokuma.
Mother Kuma receives the footage and parses it before sending it off to Monokuma. You mean like a security camera?
They're so small that they can't be seen with the naked eye. They must be the security cameras. The sixth Monokub has been added to your truthful section of your Monopad. What else?
So there were security cameras after all.
Hey.
They've been recording the footage wirelessly. Weren't there regular cameras though? Or maybe I'm tweaking. Actually, I think I'm tweaking. I know there was at least the monitors, but maybe there weren't actually any cameras. Kokichi was correct to use the electro bomb. Oh, wait, no, yeah. I guess the electro bomb would just stop all those cameras too, huh? When he used it, the Nanokumas weren't able to send any footage back to Monokuma.
You're right.
Yes, in that case, I doubt Monokuma knew the real culprit.
The more I learn, the more I wish that Kokichi had just worked with us normally.
But
that's impossible. No matter how many times he reincarnates,
He's a liar down to his soul. I never would have imagined that the 6 Monocode would be would be security cameras. That's how Monokuma was able to keep watch of this entire academy. He's toying with us. He's not just confident, he's sure he's going to win. I know that must be what he's thinking.
Oh yeah.
At least we know that important detail now. I'm glad you told us before the class trial.
Thank you.
Yeah, thanks, Kibo.
By the way.
You're welcome, but we should get going now.
That's true.
Yeah, we don't know what Monokuma will do if we show up late. You're right. Then let's start heading to the trial grounds.
Okay.
Here we go. Alright, statue, you're not holding the... Oh, you're not holding anything. It's not even moving. It's just gonna go underground. It's not even underwater. There's no more water left. Hey, don't fall. Oh, never mind. The floor closes, so you can't fall on accident. That's good. It's nice to be safe. Safety first. I'm glad Monokuma is thinking about our safety when we're going to the trial grounds. Alright, let's go. There's no point in worrying anymore right now. We only need to think about getting out of here alive. And so we put the destroyed Ultimate Academy behind us and headed to the final trial ground. Dun, dun, dun. Carrying the last of the survivors, the elevator brought us down. What could be waiting for the five of us? I'm sure this is the end of despair and the beginning of hope. Everything ends here. Everything. Ooh, it's getting really intense. The killing game of Hope's Peak Academy, the killing game of Jabberwock's Island, and the killing game of this Ultimate Academy. How much more until they're satisfied? This is the end of it. I'm tired of this. We're going to end it. We're going to end this cruel game. Achievement unlocked. Class trial of the century. Ooh. New trial ground. It's looking interesting. So, this is the final trial ground.
It's not up to you or me to decide whether or not this is the end.
What do you mean?
More importantly, since you guys requested that we hold this class trial, I'm sure you won't mind allowing me to participate too, right?
Right.
It'll be easier to argue if I do.
That's true.
True. I was going to have you participate this time. But I didn't think you'd volunteer.
What is it?
You seem confident.
With my magic.
You're confident now. But I'm going to turn your body into an omnibus with my magic.
Actually.
Yeah, not enough friends left. Oh, no. An omnibus? Do you mean the vehicle or like a compilation book or...
Knock it off. I won't be provoked by your cheap threats.
He seems really provoked.
Yeah, but...
If Pops is gonna participate, things are gonna get pretty dang interesting.
Father!
You can do it, Father!
Rock hard,
we'll cheer you on until our voices are hoarse and bleeding, right, Monodam?
There she is, beautiful.
Cheer me on, you guys are totally participating too!
Why are they so shocked? What? Hey, come on, everyone's joining the party. Look, 5 plus... We got 11 people here? That sounds like a party!
You kids have a pivotal role to play. What kind of dad would I be if I hogged the spotlight? And if you kids don't play a pivotal role, then what use are any of you?
Pivotal role? Could we really do it?
I don't know.
Don't worry. As a good parent, I will do my darndest to motivate you.
Well,
with this button!
What's that button for?
It's a monocup detonator that I prepared to ensure my adorable kids do their very best.
The detonator?
Yep, with the push of this button, I'll detonate the bombs inside each of your bodies. So make sure you try really hard or I'll start pressing this button, got it?
That's too far!
You know what they say, if your kids are cute, put a bomb inside them.
Stupid.
That's not a real saying.
I know you cute kids can do this, you just need the proper motivation. So no need to worry, just make sure you all play pivotal roles, that's all.
Oh no. How absurd.
I knew it.
You really are the worst.
I'm the best at being the worst, don't you think so?
Hey, he's not wrong. He's definitely not wrong.
I tell ya, people can't get enough of my crude antics. Alright, let's get started. Let's get this crude climax underway.
Here we go, the save point right before the class trial. And this is where we're going to finish up the stream for today. And tomorrow will be the, we'll finish up probably the entirety of the game. Well, not the entirety of the, I don't know if there's anything after the class trial. Because I know there's an epilogue in Danganronpa 2, which I didn't actually see. So I might stream that, I might not, I don't know. I'll figure that out tomorrow, but yes. Tomorrow is going to be the ending, the climax of the main story. We're going to figure this all out. We're going to figure everything out. And thank you guys so much for coming through. If you're watching this, the VOD on YouTube, or if you're watching the VOD on Twitch, or if you're watching it live on Twitch, thank you so much. I really do appreciate it. And yes, I will see you tomorrow, hopefully, with the finale. Yep, I don't think I have anything left to say. See you later. Peace.